Here's another one, all right?
Okay.
Because this one kind of was amazing me when I was going through it last night. When you score first, and you think in baseball, you get a run in the first inning, it normally doesn't hold up. And it hasn't at times for you guys. But, again, you scored first last night. You squandered a couple leads, but you still won. So mm-hmm. you scored first and won.
Right.
When you score first, you're 28-2.
Wow.
Which, again, you think that wouldn't be a number like that. But when you score first, you're 28-2, which, again, there's no explanation for it, is there?
No, I can't think of one. I mean, it's like the one that you told me last year. I think in one-run games we were whatever for whatever. And
right.
I'm like, wow, that's, you know, just that's baffling. No, I don't have an answer for that one. The only thing I could think of, I guess, is that it gives you that energy and that extra confidence at the beginning of the game, knowing that you can put up runs when you need to. And but, I mean, to be 28-2 and hold that, you know, throughout the game and hold that mentality, you know, that's quite the astonishing stat.
Yeah, just because, again, like, get a run here in the first. Yeah, you score first, but it's a one run early in the game, and normally it doesn't hold up, or sometimes it does, but sometimes it go 50-50, not so far this year. And then when the opponents score first, you're 5-12. So, again,
well, you can't have both sides of the coin, can we?
Can. Still, it all works out pretty good to be 33-14 right now. This last week of the regular season, you just mentioned some good news to me that happened, and you always like to see guys move on. Kyle Richards, he got some good news, didn't he? And he's no longer with you.
No, he's not. He had a tryout today with the T-Bones, and it ended up being where he signed. And he's in uniform tonight.
That's
down
crazy.
In Kansas City, and it's, you know, it's a great thing for him. I mean, he's put 4 years of really hard work in. You know, he's been from place to place and trying to find his niche, and he's went to a bunch of workouts this year and you know, got some good news, but then it turned out to be, you know, nothing. And you know, for him to kind of stay with us and keep working hard. And, I mean, his batting average and his numbers, I think, are probably the best that he's ever had, you know, since his first year here. And for him to get that opportunity to move on to the next level is, you know, I'm so happy and I'm so proud for him.
Yeah, that's what you guys, again, that's part of what you do and try and get guys to the next level. And again, love to see those guys succeed. And he's been a guy that his transition, I'm guessing you even know, well, you do know way more than I do about Kyle from when he first got here to now when he is leaving. And boy, he has changed in his 4 years, hasn't he?
Oh, he has. The maturity level is a drastic change. I mean, when he was here as a freshman, he was having fun.
He was a kid.
Doing what he needed to do, and he was bouncing around, and nothing got to him. And, you know, he got to the middle, and he was kind of trying to find himself. And now that he's in his fourth year, I mean, I watched him more determined, a great leader. I mean, he's going to be missed in that outfield because, man, he could you know, patrol the gap to gap. You know,
he was swinging it this year, man.
Offensively,
he
looked phenomenal. I mean, he was
different player,
taking the ball the other way. He was just doing a lot of smart things, and I'm glad that he's getting the chance to move on.
The nice thing is you have depth, and you have depth in the outfield. You have guys that can roam center field much like he can, and it shouldn't hurt you, should it?
No, it shouldn't. I mean, we got Richardson. We can throw on center field. Jordan Powell did a nice job last night, made some big plays for us. You know, Rencio is that flex guy where we can move wherever we want. You know, Scott and Wright, we still can put Trent out there when we need to. We just got a lot of flexible guys, so it's not going to hurt us, I guess, from a rotational standpoint, but it's just going to be, I think, a guy that we're going to miss in the clubhouse.
Yeah, absolutely. We're talking Matt Johnson. We'll end with this. Blake Collins gets the start tonight, and again, his numbers have been phenomenal. He's 4-0 with a 2.01 ERA, whether it be out of the pen, a spot start. Now he's kind of a guy in your rotation all of a sudden, but he's done a great job, hasn't he?
He has, and he's one of those guys that's been with us for 3 years. And
yep.
His first year was kind of up and down. Last year he kind of found his niche, and then this year he's getting an opportunity to take advantage of his last, you know, go-around with baseball and doing a really nice, phenomenal job as a starter. And kind of filling the roles when we need them. So I'm looking for a good outing from him tonight.
And he's had a bunch of good outings in a row now, hasn't he?
He has. The confidence level is so much higher for him at this point. And it's the guy that I saw 3 years ago that I knew he could be this.
Yeah.
And it took him three years to find it. But, you know, it's well-deserved for him to get to this point.
And your lineup, pretty much the same as what you had last night. Will we kind of see that this last week of the season, or will you still rotate some guys in?
We'll rotate some guys in here and there. It's probably not going to be as much as we've done in the past.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because we're going to get kind of into that set core lineup that we're going to have where we'll have two or three guys that will pull off the bench, but very rarely will we flex it around a lot. But, you know, what you've seen tonight is probably going to be what we consistently stay with down the stretch.
Thank you, Coach. Good luck tonight.
All right, thanks, Dave.
Appreciate it. Matt Johnson, manager of the Mustangs, as we get set for Mustangs baseball against the Chillicothe Mudcats coming up this evening. Let's get a break, and we'll come back with the starters' first pitch. That's all next as we roll on from Schaefer Field here in Chillicothe. This is Mustangs baseball on ESPN 1550.
Make it fast.
I'd like to work here at Jimmy John's World's Greatest Gourmet Sandwich Shop, sir.
Why do you want to work at Jimmy John's, kid?
I'm perfect for Jimmy John's.
Doing what?
Delivery.
Delivery?
Delivery.
We deliver pretty fast here at Jimmy John's.
That's what I heard.
What'd you hear?
You deliver pretty fast here at Jimmy John's.
Then you heard right.
I'm a fast study, sir.
You know the Jimmy John's slogan?
The Jimmy John's slogan?
Jimmy John's slogan is sub so fast you'll freak.
Sub so fast you'll freak is a swell slogan, sir.
When people call for a Jimmy John's sandwich, they want it fast.
Then I'm your man, sir.
How so?
Because I'm fast.
Fast at what?
Fast at everything.
Can you deliver fast?
I can deliver fast.
How fast?
I can run a 440 and 220.
Minutes?
No seconds.
That's fast. You deliver before?
I deliver newspapers. Before.
Were you fast?
Very fast.
How fast?
People got tomorrow's paper today.
That's fast.
So do I have the job?
Not so fast. How do I know you're not just some fast talker?
I can get your references.
When?
Now.
These are good references.
Thank you.
But at Jimmy John's, you gotta be more than fast.
More than fast.
You gotta be polite.
Fast and polite.
Fast and polite.
I can do fast and polite.
Okay, give me some time to think it over.
Okay.
Okay, I thought it over. When can you start?
Now.
Now's good. What's your name, kid?
Stefan Avalavadopoulos.
Too long. How about Ed?
That's fine.
Welcome aboard, Ed.
Jimmy John's. Freaky, fast delivery. Order online at jimmyjohns.com.
The grass and garden is growing, and Deere Equipment in Savannah is your source for lawn and garden equipment. They've got the complete lineup of Woods mowers, Kubota utility mowers and tractors, Cub Cadet mowers, and Land Pride equipment attachments. Everything you need to keep your lawn and garden looking great all year long. Deere Equipment is here to help, from commercial to residential. Deere has the lawn care equipment you need. Stop by Deere Equipment for your lawn and garden equipment on Highway 71 north of Savannah.
The first day of school is just around the corner. United Way stuffed the bus. School Supplies Drive is an opportunity to come together to ensure that area children begin school with the supplies they need. United Way stuffed the bus. School Supplies Drive will take place at both St. Joseph Walmart stores on August 7th and 8th. Deliver your donated supplies to the school bus parked at the Walmart stores in St. Joseph. Help prepare our children for success in school by donating school supplies. United Way stuffed the bus. School Supplies Drive is sponsored by Mosaic Life Care. Thank you for living United.
You're listening to Sneak Look at Mustangs Baseball on ESPN 1550.
Dodge 26, that's right. I've got it. It's like a nice thing to do. The only thing is, it's like,
we continue, as I talk to Austin Aspergen. He's trying to convince me of some other stuff. He should come on the broadcast. You're not throwing it all tonight, are you, Austin? You're not throwing it all tonight, are you? Probably. He should come on the broadcast. Talk to him. Talk to him. Again, Dave Rickard back in Chillicothe. Thanks for joining us for Mustangs Baseball tonight. St. Joseph taking on the Chillicothe Mudcats. And, again, I just talked to Dan Gerson, the owner of the St. Joseph Mustangs, and right now Sedalia, as we're trying to work around their schedule, they are going to make up just one more game. They had one more makeup with Nevada, one more with Ozark. They're going to make up their Ozark game tomorrow instead of a non-league game with the Kansas City Monarchs. So again, if he and I are doing our math right, with the Mustangs right now have a two-game lead on Chillicothe. If the Mustangs win tonight, that would put them up 2.5, and say you could not catch the St. Joseph Mustangs. So I think tonight, magic numbers down to 1. If they win tonight, they clinch the Mink League North over the Sedalia Bombers. So, again, it's a little bit speculative right now, but we think that's what it is at this point in time as the Mustangs take on the Chillicothe Mudcats. Let's meet these starters this evening as our starting lineup tonight. They're on ESPN 1550, are brought to you by Summit Truck Group. For over-the-road, severe service, and medium-duty truck needs, see Summit Truck Group or online at summittruckgroup.com. For the Mudcats, they'll go like this. Joey Morales will lead things off and play shortstop. Garrison Schwartz will play center field, and he will hit second. John Remick will hit third, and he is the catcher. Josh Ethier is the third baseman, and he will hit fourth. Tyler Burns hits fifth, and he will play first base. Aaron Creer is the right fielder, and he will hit sixth. Zach Douglas will play left field and hit seventh. Cameron Haynes is the DH, and he'll hit eighth. Isaac Gonzalez will hit ninth and be the second baseman. Caleb Bounds, the pitcher from Savannah, will start tonight for the Chillicothe Mudcats. For the St. Joseph Mustangs, they'll go like this this evening. Aurencio Fisher will lead things off and play in left field. Jacob Richardson will hit second and play in center tonight. At first base is Trent Hill, and he will hit third. The cleanup batter is Ramsey Scott, and he is the DH this evening. Playing third and hitting fifth is Josh Cassidy. Hitting sixth and playing right field is Scott Brerin. Max Ayub is behind the plate tonight, and he will hit number 7. Jerry Houston is the second baseman, and he will hit 8th. And then Jackson Schnurbusch is a shortstop, and he will hit number 9 for Matt Johnson's St. Joseph Mustangs. Blake Collins is on the mound tonight. Blake, as we talked about in pregame with Coach Johnson, has been outstanding. He just wrapped up his senior year at Central Missouri, but he is 4-0 He's made four starts. He's thrown 2 7-inning complete games, made 9 appearances. So he's been out of the pen 5 times and been a starter 4 times. This is his 5th. He got a start and a win against this team as he threw a complete game, 7-inning game, and picked up a win over Chillicothe, his last start against the Mudcats. But so far, Blake is 4-0 with a 2.01 earned run average, 28 strikeouts in 31 1/3 innings, allowed only 21 hits. He's walked 16 so far this season. So Blake Colon's on the hill tonight for St. Joseph. But the lineup is Fisher, Richardson, and Hill, followed by Scott, Cassidy, and Brerin, and then Ayub, Houston, and Schnurbush for the St. Joseph Mustangs as they come in 33-14, and they are 26-13 in Mink League play. Mudcats are out of it. They will not make the postseason. They are 24-17, 21-17 in Mink League play, but they are 3-2 against the St. Joseph Mustangs so far this year. We'll come back with the first pitch as we continue with St. Joseph Mustangs baseball right here on ESPN 1550.
What's Johnny doing now? What's your problem, man?
Over 500 slots and high-intensity table games for fun and excitement. Great food at delicious prices in the River's Edge Cafe, Buffet, and Lounge. And more fun when you're an A-Play Club member. Exclusive offers, comps, and free gifts. The more you play, the more you win. Get your game on at the St. Joe Frontier Casino at the Highland Exit, number 7, off Interstate 229 in St. Joe. Must be 21. Gambling problem? Call 1-888-BETS-OFF.
Summit Truck Group in St. Joseph provides total transportation solutions to truck owners who wish to balance quality products, services, and price. Summit has ASE certified technicians for warranty work on Caterpillar and Cummins engines, Allison transmissions, International and Workhorse products, MaxForce engines, and parts for all makes and models. For international parts and service needs, stop by Summit Truck Group in the Mitchell Woods Business Park, east of Riverside Road in St. Joseph. Summit Truck Group, a higher standard of value.
We say it can never happen to us, but the truth is, seven out of every ten people who died in Missouri car crashes weren't wearing their seatbelts. That's 70%.
That's 70%
of people just like me. The truth is, it could happen to us. Buckle up and arrive alive. Visit SaveMoLives.com.
This is St. Joseph Mustangs Baseball on ESPN 1550.
Dave Rickard back in Chillicothe, Missouri. Thanks for joining me for Mustangs Baseball tonight. Orencio Fisher's 21st birthday tonight. He's going to lead things off for the St. Joseph Mustangs, as he will be a senior at Missouri Western. But Orencio Fisher will lead things off here in just a second. Mustangs Baseball here on ESPN 1550 is brought to you by Horizon Equipment, John Deere, also by Anderson Ford Lincoln Superstore, Countryside Veterinary Clinic, Knockouts, Ground Round Bar and Grill, Kansas City Power Light, and also by Lanham Music, as we are just about set for baseball here from Chillicothe. We're at Schaefer Park in Chillicothe as the Mustangs and Mudcats meet for the 6th and final time this season. The Mudcats, though, have had some success against St. Joseph as they are 3-2 so far against the Mustangs. They've played 2 doubleheaders this year that they've split, as they split 2 games at Phil Welch. As St. Joseph got a 7-0 victory and they lost 3-1. Then they split here in Chillicothe. Mustangs won 4-2, then lost 5-2, and then they played in St. Joseph back on July the 10th, and the Mustangs lost on that Friday by a score of 7-1. But we are set for baseball as Orencio Fisher will lead things off. He'll face off against Savannah's Caleb Bounds as he makes his 2nd start against the St. Joseph Mustangs, as Orencio is hitting 288. on the season. Here's the first pitch from Bounds. It is in there for strike number one. We are underway. First pitch comes at 8:03. Temperature is 84 degrees here in Chillicothe. Our time and temp brought to you by Rock Ridge Steel Company. At Rock Ridge Steel, we customize your metal needs like no other company and create quality and precise metalwork at competitive rates. You can visit them online at rockridgesteel.com. So we're going to miss by Aurencio Fisher, and now it is a no ball and two strike count to 0 as he is down to the count to Caleb Bounds. Here's the 0-2 pitch in the dirt for ball number one. One ball, two strikes. Mustangs just underway. Here on the road this year, they're 11-7, so a good road record for the Mustangs, well above 500. All those games have been in Mink League play, no non-league games away from home. Pitch in the dirt again on an off-speed pitch from Caleb Bounds. Count is evened up, two balls and two strikes now to leadoff man for the Mustangs. Aurencio is hitting .288, a homer, 13 driven in. He has scored the second most runs of any player in the Mink League as he has scored 38 so far this season. He swings it right-handed, swings and fouls it back to the screen this time. It is a foul ball. Stays alive. He's seen five pitches so far, 2-2 count. Jacob Richardson on deck and then Trent Hill for the Mustangs. Here in the top of inning number one. Here's the Bounds 2-2 pitch. It's popped up to shallow right center field. Could be trouble. Cryer comes in, and he gets called off by the center fielder Schwartz, who will make the catch, as Garrison Schwartz will call him off and make the catch in a right center field. So a fly out to the center fielder for the first out here in inning number one. That'll be Jacob Richardson, who will hit for the Mustangs, the center fielder tonight. Mainly played left, but now with Kyle Richards playing with the T-Bones, that'll give Jacob a chance to play in center field a little bit more, but he's been fine when he's played there so far this season. There's a fastball right at the knees for strike number one. Jacob on the season is averaging out .298. A home run, 21 runs batted in so far this year, 29 runs scored. Off speed stays upstairs and outside for a 1-1 count. Trent Hill is on deck for the Mustangs. St. Joseph has won five of their last six, including that dramatic win in 10 innings last night. Ooh, he couldn't check his swing that time. Goes around. So a swing and a miss there. Makes it a ball and two strikes from Bounds to Jacob Richardson. Jacob hit .263 this past year at Barton Community College. Here's the 1-2. Fastball is fouled away off to the left side. It remains a ball and two strikes to Jacob Richardson. Richardson has struck out 25 times, walked 23, has 17 stolen bases on the season. He bats left-handed, the Goddard, Kansas native. The pitch in the dirt, two balls and two strikes now. Making Bounds work. Again, Aurencio was able to see seven pitches. Four so far here in this at-bat for Jacob Richardson. Nobody on, one out here in the top of the first inning. No scores. We are just underway. Here's the Bounds pitch. Curveball, called strike three outside corner, and that'll be the first strikeout for Caleb Bounds. And two up, two down for the Mustangs here in inning number one. That will bring up Trent Hill. Trent had two hits in last night's game. Also got the save in last night's game. Tonight he's playing first base. He'll be a senior at Lee University. The Bentonville, Arkansas native has been red hot. He is hitting now .344 on the season. Drove in two runs in last night's win. He was 2-for-4, scored two runs, drove in two runs, and got the save. Here's the pitch. Ground ball up the middle. To his right is the second baseman, Gonzalez, and he will throw out Trent Hill by a step, and that will retire the Mustangs in order in the opening frame. They go in order. Mudcats will come to bat for the first time when we return. No score here in Chillicothe. This is St. Joseph Mustangs baseball on ESPN 1550.
Steel. The area's steel superstore in Elwood, Kansas has steel for construction. Bars, beams, tubing, pipe, sheet, and plates. Steel for farms. Steel for DIY projects. Sunrooms, basements, and garages cut to your specifications. For a free estimate on the best price steel in Nebraska, Iowa, Missouri, and Kansas, call Dan Riley at 913-365-5200. At Rock Ridge Steel. Rock solid steel. At rock bottom prices.
Hey guys, are you tired of feeling awkward and out of place when you go to get your hair cut? You don't have to anymore. Gentlemen, meet your new favorite chair at Knockouts. Simply walk in, help yourself to a beverage, and watch the game on the flat screens. Relax and feel the stresses of the day melt away with a complimentary scalp massage. You'll leave looking like the distinguished gentleman that you are. Knockouts. 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 And grooming for men behind UMB Bank on Belt and Frederick.
Hey, parents of children with asthma, here's another hit from the Breathe Easies.
Come on and clean up the mold. Clean up. up the mold. Whoa. Mold can trigger asthma in kids young and old. Come on and clean up the mold. Whoa. Clean up the mold in your house.
This song may be fun, but childhood asthma is not. Preventing asthma attacks can be as simple as cleaning up the mold and mildew in your house. For more Breathe Easy tips to help stop asthma attacks, go to noattacks.org. Brought to you by the EPA.
You're listening to St. Cricket Mustangs Baseball on ESPN 1550.
Dave Rickard back in Chillicothe. Thanks for joining me for Mustangs Baseball tonight. Jim Bly with me as well this evening on uclicktv.com. Blake Collins will get the start tonight. His fifth start here in 2015. Blake is 4-0 so far this year with a 2.01 earned run average, including a 7-inning complete game against these same Chillicothe Mudcats. No scores. We go to the bottom half of inning number one. And for the Mudcats, they will have Joey Morales leading things off, the shortstop. Morales plays at Nicholls State. He's from Fort Myers, Florida, just wrapped up his freshman year. And as we mentioned earlier in the year when we broadcasted a game against the Mudcats, this is a very young squad, a lot of freshmen and sophomores in their lineup. Pretty talented club, but some of their stars are not in the lineup tonight. A couple that are all-stars in the Mink League. There's a first pitch fastball for a strike on the outside corner. So Blake Cullen starts out Morales with a strike on the outside corner as Morales is hitting .221 so far this summer. No homers and three RBI. He's played in 26 games in that leadoff spot. Looks at a strike again on a fastball from Blake Cullen, and now Blake's way ahead. No balls and two strikes. In this game, starting an hour later than usual because of rain in the area. They had some rain midday today as well. They've had a lot more rain in this area than what we've had in St. Joseph. Tries an off-speed pitch. Checking his swing was Morales. Did not go around. It's a ball. One ball, two strikes. Now the count to Joey Morales. Morales, 5'10", 180-pound right-hander. Can just wrap up his freshman year at Nicholls State. This is his 27th game he's played in. Just 9 strikeouts so far in the games he's played. Has walked 6 times. Now a pitch high and away for ball number 2. It's evened up. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Nobody out here in the bottom of inning number 1 as we are just underway. No score. Fastball lined to left field. Coming on is Arencio Fisher, though. He'll leap up and make the catch. Took a step back, then took 2 steps forward, then was able to leap up and make the catch on a hard hit ball right at Arencio Fisher. So a line out to left. And that's the first down here in inning number 1. I'll bring to the plate Garrison Schwartz.
The center fielder.
Schwartz was a freshman this past year. As you just heard, plays at Grand Canyon University. He's from Chandler, Arizona. Grand Canyon, certainly by the name of the university, is in Arizona. Lefty-lefty matchup here. There's a fastball a little bit outside and high for ball number 1. Schwartz on the season. Playing center field tonight, hitting .282, no homers and 13 RBI. He was a starter this past year as a freshman for Grand Canyon University, Division I school, low and inside. 2 balls and no strikes now the count to Schwartz. Garrison Schwartz, 6'1", 205-pound left-hander, went to Desert Vista High School. He hit .357 this past year as a true freshman at Division I. There's a fastball right down the middle for strike number 1. So 2-1 the count now as Blake will try and come back from that 2-1 deficit. 2-1 count, rather. John Remick, their catcher, is on deck. If anybody reaches, they'll have Josh Ethier, the third baseman, bat here in this first inning. In the dirt, makes it 3 balls and a strike now as Collins falls behind Garrison Schwartz, trying to avoid getting a runner on base with 1 down. 1 out, nobody on base right now. And we are just underway. Here's the Collins 3-1 pitch. Missed a little bit high. Walks him on 5 pitches. It's one thing with Blake at times. He's almost got a strikeout per inning. 28 strikeouts in 31 and one-third innings, but he's walked 16 this year, so that's a little bit high. Last year in 28 and two-thirds, he struck out 24, but also walked 16. His first year with the Mustangs in 2013, this is a 3-year guy, he pitched in 25 innings and struck out 36. That year, he certainly had more than 1 strikeout per inning. He starts him off speed, and Remick, an all-star this year in the Mink League North, he swings and misses on that off-speed pitch, and Remick is now down. No balls and a strike to Blake Collins. Remick plays his college baseball at the University of Kansas. He's hitting .330, 3 homers, 13 driven in. Another off-speed pitch is fouled back and out of play. 0-2 as Collins is way ahead of Remick now. Remick from San Diego went to Torrey Pines High School. He's in his second year at the University of Kansas. Only played in 10 games in 2 years, has not made a start for the Jayhawks, and he's 0 for 6 in his career at KU. So hasn't got a lot of playing time, but has had a nice summer with the Mudcats. Again, hitting 330. Max Aib wants it low, and a foul tip just stays alive as the ball trickles behind home plate. Almost got the strikeout on a fastball inside, but it's foul back. No balls, two strikes, one out, one on for Chillicothe here in the bottom of the first inning. No score. Blake McFadden will send the sign in to Max Aib. He relays it to Blake Collins, and here's the pitch. Tries a fastball in the outside corner and just missed. One ball, two strikes now the count. Collins to John Remick. He swings it right-handed, 6'2", 190-pound right-hander. Was 0 for 4 in the games he hit for KU this past year, played in 7 games. Here's the 1-2 again. Curveball on the ground toward short. Schnurbusch flips it. Houston's turn is in time. 6-4-3 double play. And that will end the inning as Blake Collins throws 15 pitches and gets the 6-4-3 double play to end it as we are through one complete. No score between Chillicothe and St. Joseph right here on ESPN 1550.
And to visit Horizon Equipment, your local John Deere dealer. They're just a few miles east of St. Joseph on 36 Highway, and they have a wide selection of John Deere riding mowers, zero-turn mowers, and garden tractors. Let their professionals help fit you to the right equipment for your job. They also have a top-notch John Deere parts and service department, and if you want it to run like a Deere, it has to be a Deere. Give them a call today and find out about discounts and financing options. You'll find a full line of John Deere at Horizon Equipment at Route C and 36 Highways just east of St. Joseph.
It takes hard work and dedication to have a winning team. The Mustangs showed us this last season, and here at the new Anderson Ford, we share the same commitment to our customers. Whether it's sales or service, the new Anderson Ford will serve your needs by always doing what is right. Stop by and check out the new Anderson Ford, 2207 North Belt Highway.
Anderson Ford, your regional Ford superstore. Online at AndersonAutoGroup.com.
It's one of the busiest times of the year to buy and sell real estate in Northwest Missouri. So Mustangs fans, step up to the plate and hit a home run when you choose Reese Nichols Ide Capital Realty to be part of your team. From new construction homes to townhomes, investment properties, commercial listings, and more, we've got all the bases covered. Why choose us for your real estate journey? Our agents, our expertise, our partners. Call Reese Nichols Ide Capital Realty today. We must be doing something right.
Dave Rigger back inside Schaefer Field, Schaefer Stadium here in Chillicothe. Thanks for joining me for Mustangs baseball tonight. St. Joe's Summer College baseball team taking on the Chillicothe Mudcats. The Mudcats 3-2 against St. Joseph this year, including a game which kind of got the Mustangs going. They lost a game 7-1 to Chillicothe on Friday, July the 10th, and since that point in time, they have gone 8-2. So they have played very good. Now it is 7-2. 7-2. Pretty good with numbers. Had to make sure that time. Ramsey Scott will lead things off. He swings and misses at a fastball from Caleb Bounds. Bounds, again, the Savannah native. He plays at William Woods University. He was 2 years at North Central Missouri College, was a teammate of Blake McFadden's, the pitching coach for the Mustangs in high school. Blake got most of the coverage because of what he did, but Caleb Bounds, certainly a good pitcher as well. Fly ball to center field is going to be cut easy by Garrison Schwartz, so a two-pitch out as he got under that one and flies out to center field. But Bounds has had a good year. He was an all-star this year as well, and he's 4-3, but has a 2.5 ERA, 2.50 in 39 and two-thirds innings. He's made 6 starts. This is number 7. This is his 11th appearance overall. He has struck out 18 and walked 22. That's been his issue so far this year. He's allowed just 32 hits in 39 and two-thirds innings. Now Josh Cassidy will step in. The Mustang third baseman hitting right-handed with Scott Brerin on deck. Here's the pitch from Bounds. Tries a fastball, missed high and away from ball number 1. So Bounds, again, he got overlooked in high school just because of what Blake McFadden did, but he had a nice career, and those two helped get Savannah to a state championship game against Westminster Academy. They'd lose in that state championship game, but got there and came up just a little bit short. There's a swing and a miss on an off-speed pitch as Josh Cassidy is hitting 281. No homers, 21 runs batted in so far this season. He scored 19 runs, has 10 extra base hits, 8 doubles and 2 triples. He just wrapped up his senior season at Arkansas Pine Bluff. Fastball misses high, and now it's a 2-ball and 1-strike count with one down. No score. As we are in the top of the second inning, now a pitch in the dirt, 3 balls and a strike. Leadoff man was retired on a flyout to center field. Now Josh Cassidy bats with nobody on, a 1-out. He's ahead, 3 balls and a strike. The bounce pitch is going to miss outside for a 5-pitch walk. Mustangs have their first base runner on. So that'll bring up Scott Brereton. So Brereton will hit. He's followed by Max Ayoub in this lineup tonight, and then Jerry Houston and Jackson Schnurbush. So Brereton hitting in the 6th hole this evening, playing right field. He'll swing it left-handed. Had a ground-out RBI in last night's game. And for Scott on the year, he's hitting now 244. 2 homers, 15 runs batted in. He checks his swing on a curveball low this time for ball number 1. Scott got out to a hot start this year. He'll be a sophomore at Boston College. Average has dipped down to 244. Here's a fastball that misses outside. I think Bounds a little unhappy with the home plate umpire right now, but he has thrown now 6 balls in his last 7 pitches. Mustangs a runner at first base with Josh Cassidy. He has stolen 9 bases in 10 attempts. Now a check swing and a foul by Scott Brereton this time will make it a 2-ball and 1-strike count. Tried to check his swing in a high fastball, but it caught the barrel of the bat and ricocheted over to the left side. No score, top of the second. 1 on, 1 out for St. Joseph, trying to break through. As I mentioned, when they score first, they're pretty good, 28-2. Here's the pitch by Caleb Bounds. Curveball, he swings and misses. And now it's a 2-ball and 2-strike count. Brereton has still struck out less than the amount of times he's walked this year, 21 walks, 15 Ks. Did strike out one time in last night's game of the bases loaded. Pitch is high to make it full. 3 balls and 2 strikes to count to Brereton now. One out here in the top of the second. Scoreless here in Chillicothe. Bounds from the stretch. Cassidy not a very big lead at first base. Burns holds him on, and now Brereton hits a fly ball in the infield. Going to be an easy play for Ethier more than likely. He comes in near the pitcher's mound, and he will make the catch on the infield. So Brereton on a 3-2 pitch pops up on the infield, and that is his second out here in the inning. That'll bring up Max Ayoub, still looking for his first hit as a Mustang. Get an RBI in last night's game on a ground out, but he will hit in the 7-hole again. So Max Ayoub will hit as he is 0 for 8 so far in a Mustang uniform. Playing in his 4th game, he was lifted for Frankie Alvarez. 7th inning of last night's game. Fastball is high and away for ball number 1. Runner at first base, 2 down. Ayoub can play at Nebraska Kearney, Grand Island, Nebraska native. He swings it right-handed. Bounds a long look in. Now a 1-0 pitch. Misses outside. 2 balls and 0 strikes. Ayoub has struck out 3 times in his 8 at-bats. He's walked 1 time, been hit by a pitch, scored 1 run, and has 1 RBI, but still looking for that first hit. After a 302 season, 17 homers and 58 runs batted in for the Lopers of Nebraska Kearney. They had a pretty good year this past year. Made the MIAA tournament at 22-14. They were the 6th seed, but they had the same record as the 4-5 seeds, Missouri Western and Washburn. So right there in the middle, they were all bunched together, and they were a good club. Now a fastball blown away makes it 3-0, so Jerry Houston may have a chance with a couple on. Three balls, no strikes. The pitch up and in. 4-pitch walk. So 2 walks in the inning, and now there's 2 on base for Jerry Houston. Well, Jerry had 2 hits, drove in his 10th run last night. He's hitting 266, but again, he had 2 hits, and he drove in the go-ahead and eventual game-winning run. See if he can come through with 2 outs here. His first pitch he sees is low, so Bounds having some trouble now, yet to allow a hit, but 2 base runners via the walk, and that's what I talked about. He's walked more guys than he struck out this year. Now it's 24-18 walks to strikeouts. Cassidy off second. Ayoub off of first base. Houston pops him up, and it's into foul territory down the third base line, coming over the shortstop. Ooh, just missed a foul ball. And he slides past it, and it was almost a fair ball. So that was almost disaster for the Mudcats as it was popped up down that third base and left field line. Overrunning it was a shortstop, Morales. He slid by it. It almost landed in fair territory. Houston with a 1-1 count. Two outs, two on for the Mustangs during the top of the second, a scoreless game. Caleb Bounds trying to work around the two walks in this inning. A one-out walk to Cassidy, a two-out walk to Ayoub. From the stretch, pitch again, curveball, and this one misses inside. Pretty tight strike zone so far. But he misses with a 2-1 count now, and Jerry Houston's ahead. Jackson Schnurbusch is on deck for the Mustangs, the St. Joseph shortstop. Here's the 2-1. Low and away, three balls and a strike. So Caleb Bounds having a heck of a time finding home plate right now. He's one more ball away from walking the bases loaded with two down. Bounds a long look in. See what he's going to throw this time as John Remick gives the sign. Bounds looks at second base. And the pitch, and it's hammered to center field. Hit very well. Going back is Schwartz, and he will run it down in center field, and that will retire the Mustangs. Houston hit it well, but not deep enough as Schwartz is able to run it down in center field, and that will retire the Mustangs as they leave two on base. We are through an inning and a half. No score between the Mustangs and the Chillicothe Mudcats right here on ESPN 1550.
The grass and garden is growing, and Dirt Equipment in Savannah is your source for lawn and garden equipment. They've got the complete lineup of Woods mowers, Kubota utility mowers and tractors, Cub Cadet mowers, and Land Pride equipment attachments. Everything you need to keep your lawn and garden looking great all year long. Dirt Equipment is here to help, from commercial to residential. Dirt has the lawn care equipment you need. Stop by Dirt Equipment for your lawn and garden equipment on Highway 71 north of Savannah.
Have you been to the Ground Round lately? It's where there's always a fusion of flavor. You'll find just what you're looking for.
Your favorite half-price appetizers, Monday through Friday. Outrageous nachos, chicken quesadilla, spinach artichoke dip, and much more.
The Ground Round has the best daily happy hour from 3 to 6 p.m. and 9 p.m. to close, offering 15 flavors of Long Island iced teas. Good friends, good times, great food. See what's new at the historic downtown Ground Round on the corner of 6th and Edmond. We've got what you like. Ground Round.
Today's Mustang game is brought to you in part by Duval Lawn Care Incorporated. Do you have unsightly weeds in your lawn? Do you want a greener, richer looking lawn? Then give Duval Lawn Care a call. Duval Lawn Care serves commercial and residential customers in St. Joseph, North Kansas City, and the surrounding area. For a personalized proposal and a great looking lawn, give the folks at Duval Lawn Care a call at 816-662-2222. That's 662-2222.
Dave Rigger back in Chillicothe. Jim Bly with me this evening, also on uclicktv.com as we roll on from Chillicothe, Missouri. The Mustangs and the Mudcats for the sixth and final time this season. St. Joseph just three games remaining in this regular season, trying to clinch, and again, we think they can clinch tonight with a win tonight. Today only has two games left, and if the Mustangs can win tonight, looks like they will wrap up the Mink League North Division Championship and have a chance for a fourth Mink League Championship in their first 7 years of existence. And again, this would be their fourth opportunity for a championship in the last five seasons. First pitch to Josh Ethier from Blake Collins is a little bit low for ball one. Blake, a 15-pitch first inning, got a double play to end it, as they did get a walk. No hit so far. Ground ball up the middle of chopper. Schnurbusch bobbles it, and he makes an error. Jackson got a good hop near his waist as he came near the bag at second base, but that'll be his second error in as many nights. He doesn't make a ton of errors, but has made back-to-back errors in consecutive nights. So an error on Jackson Schnurbusch. We'll see if Blake Collins can work around that. That'll bring up Tyler Burns, a first baseman for the Mudcats. Burns from Trevecca Nazarene University, which is in Nashville, Tennessee, a Division II university. He's from Tullahoma, Tennessee, 247 average, no homers and 7 RBI. Colon's going to throw to first base, and back is Ethier. Ethier on the year, just 2 steals and 4 attempts. He plays his college baseball at Central Arizona. Another throw to first base. Mudcats have 62 steals as a team and 82 attempts, stealing 75% of the bases that they try. Mustangs have 135 out of 163, stealing 82.8% of the tries that they, the steals that they try out on the base paths. Pitches outside for ball one. One ball, no strikes to count to Tyler Burns, the first baseman. He got a 247 average, 7 RBI, 7 runs scored, just one extra base hit, a double. Pops one up. It's going to be over by first base. Jerry Houston calls off Trent Hill. He'll make the catch as he almost bobbled it. Well, he did bobble it. It almost came out of the glove, but he makes the catch right down the first base line, right where the dirt and the grass meet beyond first base. So it was almost going to be a foul ball, but I think it was going to stay fair. But he pops up, and that leaves the runner at first base with one down now. So Jerry Houston, he has tremendous range, especially at second base. He's a really good defensive second baseman. He has tremendous range from really to the line or in foul ground to second base. I'll bring up Aaron Creer now. He bats right-handed. First pitch that Collins throws is outside for ball number one. Creer just wrapped up his sophomore year at Wayne State College in Nebraska. He's from Orillia, Iowa. Went to Storm Lake High School. Thank you. Pitch was in the dirt for ball number two. Two balls and no strikes. Collins behind now, 2-0. Got behind Ethier. And the air on Schnurbusch, fastball high and away. Now it's a 3-ball and no strike count. Career 273 hitter, no homers, 15 RBI so far this summer. He has scored 15 runs. He has struck out 18 times, walked 8. Hit 200 in 32 games this past year, and there's a called strike on the inside corner. Was going to take off toward first base, decided to return to the deck, to the batter's box. Ethier at first base on the error by Schnurbusch. Burns popped out. Now there's a called strike, so Collins tries to come back. Back-to-back strikes, and now it's a full count. 3 balls and 2 strikes with one out, one on for Chile here in the bottom of the second inning, no score. Zach Douglas is on deck. And now a ground ball wide of first base. And a good one-hand stab by Wally Marshall, the assistant coach and first base coach for Chillicothe. Collins has come back with 3 consecutive strikes. Let's see if he can get a strikeout or at least an out of some sort. Throw to first base, and Ethier is back easily. Lefty Collins comes set. Here's Blake's pitch. Missed it high and away. So came back to get it 3-2, and then he even got a foul ball, and he walked him. So Blake with his second walk in the game. There's been an error as well. 3 base runners for Chillicothe, and that brings up Zach Douglas. Douglas playing left field.
From Northwest Missouri State, the left fielder, Zach Douglas.
Douglas again plays at Northwest Missouri State. Douglas hasn't played a ton of games. He's only played in 5. He's 2 out of 14. He only played in 8 games for Northwest. He'll be a senior. He's from Chillicothe High School. Now it's going to be a line drive back to Collins. He will make the catch, throw to first base, and they get a double play on the line drive right back to Blake. Makes a nice play, and they get a double play to end the first. Now a double play to end the second as the Mustangs get out of it as Chillicothe leaves one on base after having 2 on and 1 out. We're through 2 complete, no score between St. Joseph and Chillicothe right here on ESPN 1550.
Summer's here, and it's time to get your pet ready for the outdoors at Countryside Veterinary Clinic. Whether you're looking at heartworm prevention or flea or tick control, Countryside carries products that not only work, but they couldn't be easier to give to your pets. If your pet's getting a little older, Countryside recommends getting a senior exam, a physical and blood work to let you know of any changes that need to be made, or set action to remedy any problems before it's too late. Pets are family, and Countryside Veterinary Clinic wants your family to enjoy the summer.
Hi, this is Aaron from Lanham Music, and most people know us for our great selection of instruments at prices that meet or beat the big internet stores. We also have a dedicated sound technician to install or service systems for churches, businesses, and schools. We have the most comprehensive lesson program in the area, offering recording classes, rock camp, and private instruction on over a dozen instruments. Find us at 2401 North Belt Highway or online at lanhammusic.com. Lanham Music, personal service from local musicians.
Surprising savings are coming to Missouri with the KCP&L Home Energy Rebate Show.
What am I going to do with this second fridge?
Did I hear you say second refrigerator?
Yes, but how did you...
Not important. I'll give you $75 for it through KCP&L Home Energy Rebates.
Wow, that's great. But what about...
I'll even take it away for free.
I...
Don't know what to say? I get that all the time.
See why it pays to save energy. Visit kcpl.com/save today.
You're listening to the St. Joseph Mustang. Hey, on ESPN 1550.
Dave Rigger back in Chillicothe. Thanks for joining me for Mustangs baseball tonight. St. Joe's Summer College baseball team on the road, taking on the Chillicothe Mudcats. Just two more road games remaining here in this regular season tonight, and then tomorrow night at Nevada. We won't have tomorrow night's game for you. As the Royals and Cardinals both playing at night, but have a chance to get this one for on for you. Now Jackson Schnurbusch, line drive up the middle for a base hit. Lead off singles, get a 1-0 count, and now Jackson is hitting 200 on the season. But he's been hitting much better this last month of this regular season. Gets a line drive up the middle for a base hit. First hit in the game for either club. And now back to the top of the order for Arencio Fisher, the birthday boy. Who I just go, is it really your 21st? He goes, yep, hope I can do something special today. Let's see if he can. Arencio will be a senior at Missouri Western. Second hitting for the Griffins this past season as he hit .359, had a homer, 22 RBI. He scored a team best, or second team best, 37 runs, stole 21 bags, which led the team. So had a good year for Coach Verduzco's club. Arencio bats right-handed. He flew out to center his first time up. Schnurbusch off of first base, not a big lead. Tries to bunt and bunts it back foul. He's mad at himself. So he's down, no balls and a strike. This season against the Mudcats, Arencio's played in just two games. He's 2-for-6, 2 runs scored, 2 RBI. He struck out one time, so now he's 2-for-7, including today's game against the Mudcats here in 2015. He's had a thumb injury that's bugged him for about the past month or so. Fastball hot throw down to first base, and Jackson Schnurbusch gets back safely. Close play on a good throw by Remick, the catcher. One ball, one strike, the count. No love lost with these two clubs. These two towns, really. St. Joe and Chillicothe, not huge fans, I don't think, of each other. Caleb bounds from the stretch, brings it home, and Arencio Fisher fouls it back. Was not scoring the bunt that time. 1-2 the count to Arencio. He's playing in left field tonight, had the night off last night. Did pinch run for Ramsey Scott late in the game, was caught stealing third on a throw-him-out, strike-him-out double play to end the top of the eighth inning in Sedalia. Had a chance in that inning, but could not come up with the run, but still won that game 6-5. Pitch by Bounds, curveball got him. Swing and a miss, Arencio Fisher strikes out and can't get the job done to get the man into scoring position. So one out, that will bring up Jacob Richardson. Richardson is 0-for-1 so far in the game. He struck out looking his first time up. That's the second strikeout as Arencio struck out. That's the second strikeout for Caleb Bounds. He has walked two and given up one base hit, but no runs so far as we are scoreless here in the top of the third. Richardson bats left-handed, bounds again from the stretch with a runner at first base, and in the dirt, Remick. Ooh, he's got Jackson Schnurbusch picked off as the ball got away from Remick, but it did not get too far away, and Remick throws down to first base, and he will get Jackson Schnurbusch as he crept toward second base. So pitch in the dirt and a good stop by Remick, but Schnurbusch thought it was going to get away further. It did not, and he gets picked off. So Remick guns him down, and there's two down. The base is empty now for Jacob Richardson. Ground ball wide of first base, and now it's a one ball and one strike count. And Jacob struck out looking his last time up, hitting .298 now on the season, a homer, 21 RBI. That was the 26th time he has struck out this season. Here's the bounce pitch. Curveball, strike number two. Bounds up to 44 pitches here in the third, not quite through three innings. So they've had his pitch count. They've made him work, and again, he's walked two batters already. Here's the 1-2. Just missed right at the knees, but missed outside. Two balls, two strikes, the count. Bounds will be a senior at William Woods University. A lot of William Woods guys in the Mink League this season. There's a foul ball, bouncing ball wide of first base as he pulls the curveball foul. Jacob Richardson On the season against the Mudcats is 3-for-11 against Chillicothe. Now 3-for-12. He has scored 2 runs, struck out 4 times, walked once against the Mudcats. Here's the 2-2. Curveball got him. He swings and misses. Remick will throw down to first base, and they get the strikeout. So 2 strikeouts plus a pickoff after the leadoff single. The Mustangs can't do anything with it, and that retires St. Joseph in the third. No runs, 1 hit, no errors, nobody left on base. We are through 2.5 innings. No score between the Mustangs and the Mudcats here in Chillicothe right here on ESPN 1550.
Fans, another winner, this time getting a $20 Chillicothe Fast Lanes Entertainment Center gift certificate is Scott Ellis. Scott, you can pick up your prize next to the bait shop. Designated hitter from Ellsworth Community College, number 44, Cameron Hayes.
All right, Cam.
Here we go, Blake.
Dave Rigger back in Chillicothe as we go to the bottom of the third inning. No score between the Mustangs and the Chillicothe Mudcats. Blake Collins, his first pitch he throws is a little bit low to Cameron Haynes, who is playing in his first game for the Mudcats. I think they've had some guys depart this team late in the year as they have some of their big names, some of their all-stars no longer or not in this lineup, at least tonight. Now Cameron Haynes getting his first opportunity as he plays at Ellsworth Community College. He fouls one away here and makes it a one ball and one strike count. Haynes, again, not on the roster prior to today. He has no ABs. He's not played at all against the Mustangs or anybody else in the Mink League this season. But he gets an at-bat here. And the final time these two teams play, curveball, he swings and misses on that one. He's way out in front of that. And now Collins is ahead, one ball and two strikes. Blake has only faced 7 through the first 2 innings despite having an error and 2 walks, and that is because of 2 double plays to end each of the first 2 innings, a 6-4-3 and then a line drive right back to Blake that he caught and then threw back to first base for a double play. Pitch was low and away for ball 2, 2-2 the count to Cameron Haynes. Haynes is a DH in tonight's game. Here's the 2-2 from Blake Collins. Fastball missed high and away, so Blake in danger of walking the leadoff man in the third. Haynes in the 8 hole, 8-9-1 for the Mudcats. The pitch swung on and missed. He strikes him out. First strikeout, a victim tonight for Blake Collins. Leadoff man retire for the second time in 3 innings now as Haynes swings and misses. That'll bring up Isaac Gonzalez now, the second baseman. He was a freshman this past year at Texas Pan American. From Surprise, Arizona, which a lot of people hear about Surprise, Arizona in the spring. That's where the Royals have their spring training. Speaking of the Royals, right now Alex Rios stole home in KC. It was a 5-2 lead is what I saw. No, they trailed the Pirates, 5-2 is the score, but they stole home. Rios stole home, and it's a 5-2 Pirates lead. First pitch, a called strike to Gonzalez. Now a ground ball left side of the infield. Back in it by Schnurbusch. Quick throw, and it's going to be up the line, but he tags him out. Trent Hill does. And a good job by Trent Hill to grab it and tag him out. So a 6-3 ground out. Good play in the hole at short. Had to hustle with Gonzalez, and then Trent Hill again tags him. As the throw was, I guess I should have said, down the line. First 2 retired as we go back to the top of the order now against Chillicothe, and will be Joey Morales. Morales lined out to the left fielder, Orencio Fisher, his first time up. He's out in front of this one and cues it off the end of the bat over by the Mustang on deck circle, over by their dugout. As Matt Johnson comes and gets the foul ball. No balls and a strike to Morales, the shortstop tonight for Chillicothe. Nobody on base and two down. Scoreless game in the third. Off speed, stays outside for ball number one. One ball, one strike. From Collins to Morales. Morales again a 221 hitter. On the season against the Mustangs, he is just 1-for-9 now with a walk. Pops one up. And it will be over by the Mustang dugout in foul territory. And Trent Hill couldn't quite make the play. Didn't get out of play. It was in a foul territory, but still in the ballpark. But Trent had to come a long way to get it. And again, the warning tracks here are wet. There's not standing water because they've worked it enough, but they are wet. The field is wet. You can tell the dirt is certainly very moist, to say the least. 1-2 the count with two down. See if he can get the out of Joey Morales here. This will be his 12th pitch of the inning. This will be the 39th pitch so far for Collins, and that would be a good number through three innings. We'll see if he can get the out. Morales bats right-handed. Here's Blake's 1-2. Curveball. He's out in front of it, but off the end of the bat to right field. Coming over is Scott Brenner, and he will make the catch, and that will retire the Chillicothe Mudcats in order for the first time as we are through three complete. The Mustangs and the Chillicothe Mudcats are scoreless as we continue with Mustangs baseball right here on ESPN 1550. Riggerts back inside Schaefer Stadium. We're in Chillicothe, Missouri tonight. St. Joe Mustangs taking on the Chillicothe Mudcats. No score. Good pitching battle for the first third of this game. We're through three. No score. Only one hit allowed so far in this game. That was a Jackson Schnurbusch leadoff single in the third. But he was picked off at first, then two strikeouts, and we are through three complete. New pitcher, though, for Chillicothe. Savannah's Caleb Bounds goes three innings. Allows one hit, strikes out three, and walks two, but again, no runs allowed. And now we'll see Connor Whalen, who just wrapped up his freshman year at Nicholls State. He is 2-1 so far this season. This will be his 12th appearance. 10 have been in relief. He's made two starts. 2-1 with a 6.23 earned run average. Not quite as much life in this game as what we saw in last night's game with Sedalia. And again, certainly didn't expect to see what we saw in a playoff-type atmosphere in last night's game. Trent Hill, a ground ball towards second. Going to be handled by the first baseman. Whalen covers, and Burns will throw it to Whalen as Whalen makes a good play on the ground out. 3-1 ground out as Burns came a long way to cut that off from Gonzalez, the second baseman. Thought it might turn into a problem, but it did not. First pitch that Hill sees, he grounds out, and again a 3-1 ground out. Good play by Whalen to cover. That'll be Ramsey Scott. Ramsey flew out to center field his first time up. Trent Hill now 0-for-2 in the game. Here's Whalen's first pitch to Scott. It is outside for ball number one. Whalen on the season. He's from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Went to Catholic High School there. In 21 and two-thirds innings, he's allowed 25 hits. He has struck out 17 and walked 10. So not an overpowering pitcher. Ball inside now. Two balls and no strikes to Ramsey Scott. Ramsey, after getting two hits in last night's game, is hitting .293. He had his seventh double of the year last night. There's a called strike inside corner. Ramsey at .293, five home runs, 33 RBI. The power numbers lead the Mustangs. As he's creeping back closer to .300. After 2 years at Maple Woods, he is signed to play at Murray State. Swings and misses at a low pitch this time. Now that's a two-ball and two-strike count to Ramsey Scott. He has struck out 21 times, walked 16. And he lines one down the third base line, and it will be a foul ball just barely. The lefty had it slice away from the playing field and just landed about a foot foul. On the season, Ramsey against the Mudcats has struggled this year. Again, he's had a great season, but against the Mudcats, he has not had a tremendous year. He's just 3 of 19 with 2 RBI, and he struck out 4 times, which I mentioned he's only struck out 21 all season, but only 3 for 19 against Chillicothe pitching this season. Looks one low and inside. Now the count is full, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Three and two with one out, nobody on base for the Mustangs. Josh Casty awaits on deck. Here's the pitch, and a ground ball down the first base line, and it's going to scoot, and it was just foul. Ramsey Scott says, no, that was a fair ball, wasn't it? He wanted a fair ball. It got under the glove of the first baseman Burns and would have been probably extra bases. But it is called a foul ball, and the count remains 3 balls and 2 strikes. So Ramsey Scott will get another 3-2 pitch from Connor Whalen. After a one-pitch AB, this will be the eighth pitch of the at-bat to Ramsey Scott. As Trent Hill was first pitch swinging. No score here in the top of the fourth inning. Here's the pitch. Line drive up the middle, and it's going to be kind of a blind stab by the shortstop. Morales, he just kind of put his glove out to his left, and it landed in the glove on one hop. A heck of a play by Morales, but again, sometimes better to be lucky than good, as he was a little bit lucky on that play. Stuck the glove out, it stuck in the webbing of that glove, and he throws out Ramsey Scott on a hard hit ball. So a ground out goes 6-3, and that's the second out here in the inning. Two outs, nobody on base. Josh Casty digs in. He walked his first time up, was stranded at second base back in the second inning. One of three base runners so far for St. Joseph. He swings and taps one foul off of his foot back behind home plate. So that will make it no balls and a strike with two down. And nobody on base for the Mustangs. No score here in the top of the fourth. Scott Brerin awaits on deck. Casty against the Mudcats this year is 4-15. Now 4-15 with two walks. He had walked just one time prior to his first AB. Foul ball back behind home plate again. He's down 0-2 to Connor Whalen. Whalen, 6'280-pound right-hander. Always goes from the stretch. And again, he's come on relief 10 times. This is number 10 as he comes on here in the fourth inning after Bounds throws three scoreless. And a ground ball up the middle, and it will scoot through for a two-out base hit by Josh Caston on 0-2 pitch. That'll be the second hit in the game, both from the St. Joseph Mustangs, both right back up the middle. We'll see if Scott Brenner can continue the two-out rally after the two-out base hit by Casty. Max Ayub is on deck. Scott Brenner's first time up, he popped up on the infield of the third baseman, Josh Ethier. So Whalen gives up a two-out single. So the Mustangs can do anything with it. Pitch to Brenner is off-speed, low and away for ball number one. Nothing of life in this stadium tonight. It started an hour late, a little bit later than normal. Pretty good crowd. Again, it's pretty full with the amount of stands that they have here. There's a called strike on the outside corner. Neither team real into it, it seems, right now. It's just the opposite of what it was last night with the playoff-type atmosphere in Sedalia, knowing what was on the line in that game last night. But if the Mustangs can win this, it looks like they will clinch the Mink League North Division Championship. Just missing outside is Whalen. So Brown's ahead, two balls and a strike with two down. Trying to continue the two-out rally as we are scoreless here in the top of the fourth inning. No runs, two hits, and one error for the Mustangs. 0-0-0 for Chillicothe. Barron swings and misses through an off-speed pitch. Two and two the count with two down. Whalen, 17 Ks in just over 22 innings pitched so far this year. Now Barron stays alive, popped it up. It's going to be on the infield, and it's going to stay in fair territory. Thought it might get into foul territory, and he's going to do the exact same thing he did last time and pop up to the third baseman, Ethier, on the infield, and that will end the inning. As the Mustangs strand one. They get one base hit from Josh Cassidy, and that's it. We go to the bottom of the fourth inning. No score between the Mustangs and the Chillicothe Mudcats as we continue right here on ESPN 1550 and also on uclicktv.com.
Time to visit Horizon Equipment, your local John Deere dealer. They're just a few miles east of St. Joseph on 36 Highway, and they have a wide selection of John Deere riding mowers, zero-turn mowers, and garden tractors. Let their professionals help fit you to the right equipment for your job. They also have a top-notch John Deere parts and service department, and if you want it to run like a Deere, it has to be a Deere. Give them a call today and find out about discounts and financing options. You'll find a full line of John Deere at Horizon Equipment at Route C and 36 Highways, just east of St. Joseph.
It takes hard work and dedication to have a winning team. The Mustangs showed us this last season. And here at the new Anderson Ford, we share the same commitment to our customers. Whether it's sales or service, the new Anderson Ford will serve your needs by always doing what is right. Stop by and check out the new Anderson Ford, 2207 North Belt Highway.
Anderson Ford, your regional Ford superstore. Online at AndersonAutoGroup.com.
It's one of the busiest times of the year to buy and sell real estate in Northwest Missouri. So Mustangs fans, step up to the plate and hit a home run when you choose Reese Nichols Eye Capital Realty to be part of your team. From new construction homes to townhomes, investment properties, commercial listings, and more, we've got all the bases covered. Why choose us for your real estate journey? Our agents, our expertise, our partners. Call Reese Nichols Eye Capital Realty today. We must be doing something right.
The St. Joe's Summer College Baseball Team on ESPN 1550.
Dave Bigger back in Chillicothe, Missouri. Thanks for joining us for Mustangs Baseball tonight. The St. Joe's Summer College Baseball Team taking on the Chillicothe Mudcats. We are scoreless, though, through 3.5. We're at the bottom of the fourth inning. And Garrison Schwartz will lead things off for the Mudcats, the center fielder. On the season, hitting .282, his first time up. He walked and then was doubled up on the 6-4-3 ground ball from John Remick, who was on deck. Remick on deck, and then Josh Ethier. 2-3-4 for the Mudcats. First pitch strike from Blake Collins. Collins threw 39 pitches through three innings, so he's kept the pitch count relatively low thanks to a couple of double plays. No score here in the fourth inning. Leadoff batter Schwartz swings it left-handed and a ground ball. Right side of the infield, Trent Hill has it. Collins will cover. The underhand flip. He grabs it, steps on the bag, and got him by just a step. Very close play as Schwartz, the lefty, runs well but just got there a little bit late. Good job. Collins broke late. Wasn't sure if he was going to get there in time. He broke a little bit late in covering, but it will be a 3-1 ground out. John Remick now will hit. Remick grounded into that 6-4-3 double play his last time up. Remick a 330 hitter, 3 homers, 13 RBI, but just 2 for 10 against the Mustangs this summer. Now 2 for 11 after his first AB tonight. He looks at strike number 1. And Remick, a guy that hasn't played a ton at Kansas his first couple of years. He'll be a junior again from San Diego. Now a fly ball to deep right center field. They will give chase, and Richardson will not get to it. It will one hop the wall. Remick will round second base and stay right there with a stand-up double. A rocket by Remick to right center field. And the Mustangs give up an extra base hit, and that's the first base hit allowed in the game from Blake Collins. So a runner into scoring position now after one that Richardson nearly got to. He was on his horse that time, full sprint, couldn't quite get into it, and Remick the first base hit in the game for the Chillicothe Mudcats. Remick is second base now for Josh Ethier, who is 0 for 1. He did reach base on an error by Jackson Schnurbusch, the Mustang shortstop, back in inning number 2. He bats right-handed in the cleanup spot. One on, one out, runner at second base. Here's the pitch to Ethier, and it's a called strike. Off-speed pitch that he checks his swing out, but it's a called strike. Ethier just wrapped up his sophomore year at Central Arizona College. Hit 287 there with no homers and 24 RBIs. He played for Chillicothe last year, the only player on the roster as far as position players go that played on this Chillicothe team a year ago. It's been a lot of turnover with Ty Mitchell. There's another off-speed pitch, another called strike. He's ahead 0-2 to Ethier. So he's the only holdover from last year's club. Again, it's a very young team. He hit 279 for the Mudcats last year. He's hitting 309 so far this year. It's the Mustangs. He's just 2 for 11, though. He's driven in one run against St. Joseph. He fouls one back here. Stays 0-2. Golan's got the first batter on a 3-1 ground out. And Schwartz grounded out to Trent Hill, underhanded it to Collins. Then a one-out double by Remick on an 0-1 pitch. Ethier, the 0-2 count. On deck is Tyler Burns, the first baseman. Now we're ready as Collins gets the sign from Max IU as he got it from Blake McFadden, the pitching coach. Collins comes set. Remick takes one more step off second base, and the pitch home is a curveball in the dirt for ball number one. One ball, two strikes, the count. Mustangs have a full bullpen for the most part. Austin Aspergren probably not available. If they would need Trent Hill, they probably could throw him. But those two guys ate up some innings last night, and now a throw to second base as Jerry Houston covers, and not in time as Remick gets back. Had a huge pickoff at last night's game in the eighth inning. 2-1, nobody out, and Austin Aspergren came in and walked a batter, but then picked off Trey Harris at second base for Sedalia. And they came up empty in that frame. Now a pitch low, and Ethier's come back to even up the count. 2 balls and 2 strikes. We're in the bottom of the fourth inning with no score. Remick at second base. First hit for the Mudcats in the game. It's their fourth base runner, as there have been 2 walks and an error. They've had one runner in scoring position, now a second in Remick. The pitch home, Burns out in front of it. He taps it back to the mound. Collins will throw to first base as he fields his position well and gets the out. Remick advances to third base on the ground out, but the Mustangs now an out of what? Thank you.
The first baseman, Tyler Burns.
So Remick at third base. This will be up to Tyler Burns now with 2 down. Burns hitting 247 so far. He is 0-for-1. He popped up on the infield of Jerry Houston his last time up. Burns has driven in 7 runs. Base hit could drive in his 8th right here. Missing inside is Collins. 1 ball, no strikes to count. That's his 50th pitch now here through 3 2/3 innings. Burns swings it right-handed. Just wrapped up again his freshman year at Trevecca Nazarene University. Fastball missed low. Now 2 balls and no strikes from Collins to Burns. Burns against the Mustangs is 1-for-5, has 1 of his 7 RBIs this season against St. Joseph. Tough guy to strike out, only 11 Ks on the season, and none against the Mustang pitching staff. Here's the 2-0 pitch. Ooh, he was dead red on a fastball and just missed it. He fouled it straight back to the screen. Had a good swing at that one. He was sitting on that fastball. 2-0. Just missed it, though. Now it's a 2-ball-and-1-strike count. Remick at third base. He had the 1-out double, advanced to 3rd on the ground out to Collins. Here's Blake's 2-1 pitch. Tries a fastball again. Right back to Blake on one hop. He'll run halfway to first base, underhanded to Trent Hill, and that will do it as Blake Collins gets out of it again and works around the 1-out double. In the inning, no runs, 1 hit, no errors, and 1 left on base for Chillicothe. We are now through. 4 complete, no score between St. Joseph and Chillicothe. This is Mustangs Baseball on ESPN 1550 and uclicktv.com.
The grass and garden is growing, and Deere Equipment in Savannah is your source for lawn and garden equipment. They've got the complete lineup of Woods mowers, Kubota utility mowers and tractors, Cub Cadet mowers, and Land Pride equipment attachments. Everything you need to keep your lawn and garden looking great all year long. Deere Equipment is here to help, from commercial to residential. Deere has the lawn care equipment you need. Stop by Deere Equipment for your lawn and garden equipment on Highway 71 north of Savannah.
Have you been to the Ground Round lately? It's where there's always a fusion of flavor. You'll find just what you're looking for.
Your favorite half-price appetizers, Monday through Friday. Outrageous nachos, chicken quesadilla, spinach artichoke dip, and much more.
The Ground Round has the best daily happy hour from 3 to 6 p.m. and 9 p.m. to close, offering 15 flavors of Long Island iced teas. Good friends, good times, great food. See what's new at the historic downtown Ground Round on the corner of 6th and Edmond. We've got what you like. Ground Round.
Today's Mustang game is brought to you in part by Duval Lawn Care Incorporated. Do you have unsightly weeds in your lawn? Do you want a greener, richer-looking lawn? Then give Duval Lawn Care a call. Duval Lawn Care serves commercial and residential customers in St. Joseph, North Kansas City, and the surrounding area. For a personalized proposal and a great-looking lawn, give the folks at Duval Lawn Care a call at 816-662-2222. That's 662-2222.
Dave Riggert back in Chillicothe, Missouri tonight. St. Joseph Mustangs on the road. Just two more road games left, including this one. They play tomorrow night in Nevada. St. Joseph Summer College baseball team, again, we believe if they get a win tonight, they are the Mink League North Division champions. Sedalia only has two games remaining. They play Ozark tomorrow in a makeup, and then they play the Mustangs on Thursday. Max Ayu will lead things off the Mustangs. He walked his last time up. Mustangs have two hits, no runs. Chillicothe, one hit and no runs. We are scoreless here in the top of inning number five. First pitch in there from Connor Wadeland. He's out for his second inning of work. And a called strike to Max Ayu. He walked with two outs in the second, was stranded at first base. He's 0 for 8 in three games now and make it four. He checks his swing, but he goes around and it'll be a strike. So 0 for 8 in four games now for St. Joseph. He was 0 for 2 in last night's game, was lifted for Francisco Alvarez in the seventh. Did drive and run last night with a ground out. His first RBI for the Mustangs. Wayland's off-speed pitch is a called strike. Below the knees that time a little bit. But it is. Now a 1-2 count. Wayland will step off. Wayland threw 17 pitches in the fourth inning, gave up a two-out base hit to Josh Cassidy, but he had two ground outs and a pop-up on the infield, so a pretty smooth inning for Wayland. Now out in front of it is Ayub down to third base, a backhand stab by Ethier and a throw across a diamond. Good play to back up a step and backhand it. Long throw from third, and he got Ayub, so a 5-3 ground out for the first out here in the inning. The Mustangs have had their leadoff batter on just one time now through five innings. But Ethier, a very good play at third base, and now that'll bring up the eight-hole hitter, Jerry Houston. He flew out to deep center field with two on and two outs back in inning number two. Houston 0 for 1. Jerry had two hits in last night's win over Sedalia and drove it over. Now he gets hit by the first pitch that he sees from Connor Wayland. Off-speed pitch hit him in the leg, and he will get to first base. So runner at first base with one out. St. Joseph Mustangs trying to break through here in the fifth in a scoreless game. That'll bring up Jackson Schnurbusch. He has one of the two base hits for the Mustangs, a leadoff single back in the third. Then he was picked off as the catcher John Remick blocked one in front of the plate and threw out Jackson at first base. Jerry, a pretty good leadoff at first base on the season. He has 14 steals and 15 tries. He'll be a redshirt sophomore at the University of Missouri. Here in just a few weeks, essentially, is, again, July's about over with. School's going to be starting for everybody here fairly soon. First pitch to Jackson Schnurbusch is inside for ball number one. Connor Wayland, again, 2-1, but an ERA of 6.23 on the season. Schnurbusch against the Mudcats is 3-for-9, make it now 4-for-10 with his base hit earlier in the game, and he has driven in three runs. There goes Houston, hit and run, ground ball up the middle. It's going to keep him out of a double play, and now they put a first base and got him by a step. Had to wait on that. It was a chopper. It does get the runner to second base as they avoid the double play. Schnurbusch will ground out 6-3. But Houston does get into scoring position and brings up Orencio Fisher. On his 21st birthday, the birthday boy can do something here and give the Mustangs a lead in the fifth. Orencio's 0-for-2, struck out swinging for the first out back in the third after Schnurbusch's single, and he flew out to center field back in the opening frame. So 0 is 0-for-2. Fisher's average now at 288. One home run, nearly gets hit. Now he bends down low and might have hurt his back. He does the limbo, and now he's smiling, so he's okay. He grabbed his back like he's me when I get out of bed. I'm getting old when Trenton swats me in basketball. Oh, my back. That's the excuse. Matt, ground ball off the mound, Whalen. He takes his time. Better not do that with Orencio, and Orencio stumbles over the bag, but he is out on a 1-3 ground out, and that will leave a man on base again. We're through 4.5, halfway home here in this one. The Mustangs and Mudcats are scoreless from Chillicothe as we continue with St. Joseph Mustangs baseball right here on ESPN 1550 and uClickTV.com.
A term that can mean surprise, satisfaction, or the understanding that now you get it. At Countryside Veterinary Clinic, AHA or AHA accreditation gives you peace of mind, knowing that you've made the right choice in trusting the care given to your best friend. Only 12% of animal hospitals in the United States are AHA certified, and Countryside is one of the few. So you can rest at ease, knowing that you've made the right choice for the care of your pet. Find your AHA moment at Countryside, 5025 Frederick, or check them out at countrysidevetstjoe.com.
Hi, this is Aaron from Lanham Music, and most people know us for our great selection of instruments at prices that meet or beat the big internet stores. We also have a dedicated sound technician to install or service systems for churches, businesses, and schools. We have the most comprehensive lesson program in the area, offering recording classes, rock camp, and private instruction on over a dozen instruments. Find us at 2401 North Belt Highway or online at lanhammusic.com. Lanham Music, personal service from local musicians.
Surprising savings are coming to Missouri with the KCP&L Home Energy Rebate Show.
What am I going to do with this second fridge?
Did I hear you say second refrigerator?
Yes, but how did you?
Not important. I'll give you $75 for it through KCP&L Home Energy Rebates.
Wow, that's great. But what about...
I'll even take it away for free. Don't know what to say? I get that all the time.
Royals kill the Pirates 7-4.
You're listening to Mustangs baseball.
Good little in-game commentary right now from Matt Johnson, the manager of the Mustangs. No score here in the fifth, and a complete opposite from last night. Energy, enthusiasm, everything last night. Tonight, boy, not much of it tonight.
No, there's not, and we really got to kind of start finding that. Otherwise, yeah. This game is just going to get to the point where, you know, we were last night. We're going into extra innings, and it's going to be 1-0 if it continues this way. The nice part about it is neither team is really showing any energy whatsoever. This is like watching a junior college baseball game when I was recruiting in the fall. But, you know, we need to do something that's a little bit more creative. We tried to do something that last inning with a hit and run. Just didn't work. Got the guy to second in scoring position. But, you know, we just need to create our own breaks here.
Is that what you'll try and do? Try and do some of that stuff? Try and be more creative with hit and runs and things like that to try and maybe create some energy?
Well, we're going to kind of have to. I mean, we're getting into the top of the sixth here when we come back up again. And if Blake can get us a shutout inning, we're going to have to do something creative with the top half of our lineup. I mean, we got Trent coming up and Richardson and Ramsey, and that's going to be kind of our inning. We need to put something together.
What do you see from Blake? He's throwing really well, hasn't he?
He does. He's keeping his ball down in the zone. He's challenging hitters. I mean, this is the Blake that we talked about early that's, you know, competing in the zone. And you know, for him to be 52 pitches right now through the going into the fifth, I think is you know, quite the feat.
What do you want to get him through? Do you want to get him through seven or so?
I'd like to get him through seven or eight if we can. I mean, it just depends on how he keeps throwing here. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't think four times through the lineup is something that we really want to do, but you know, we got a couple guys in the bullpen that we can kind of work with that'll make it you know, possible. So
fair ball that gets by Caskey at third base and going to try and get down to second, and he will get there as it didn't get too far away. We'll let you run, Coach. I know you got to coach your team. So.
All right. Thanks, Dave.
Thanks, Matt. Matt Johnson, manager of the Mustangs, says, again, his team scoreless with Chillicothe, but a leadoff. So it's going to be a double down the third base line. Ends up being a double from Aaron Creer as it's snuck by Josh Cassidy. And they're going to give him a hit. I thought they gave him an error for a second, but it will be a base hit. So that'll be a double down the third base line. And Creer's at second base with a leadoff double, and that will bring up the seven-hole hitter from Northwest Missouri State, Zach Douglas. Douglas is just 2 for 15 for Chillicothe so far this year. He didn't play much for Northwest. He was 2 for 10 for the Bearcats this past season. He swings it right-handed, swings through a fastball from Blake Collins here. His first time up, he lined out right to Blake for a double play. He was the second out, but then Creer, who had walked, was doubled off of first base. Runner is second. We'll see if they sacrifice. He had no intention of sacrificing on that first pitch. He looks like he's going to swing away here and does. It's going to be low for ball number one. Zach Douglas plays at Northwest Missouri State. He is from Wheeling, Missouri, but he went to Chillicothe High School, so he is a hometown kid. Again, has spent 3 years at Northwest Missouri State. Just hasn't played much for the Bearcats. Here's the pitch from Collins, and he pops it up, foul out of play off to the right side. So he's ahead 1-2. Love to get an out right here, and it's the bottom third of the order with a runner at second base and nobody down. Scoreless game here in inning number five, bottom half of the fifth. Only two hits apiece for both clubs. One error, and that was on Jackson Schnurbusch of the Mustangs. And look at second base. Collins' pitch is in the dirt. Good stop by Max Ayoub. He is shown to be a very good defensive catcher. He had a couple of great stops in last night's contest in Sedalia before getting lifted for Francisco Alvarez. But good. Max was all MIAA his last 2 years at Nebraska Kearney. And his offensive numbers, they haven't shown up so far this summer with the Mustangs, but his offensive numbers were tremendous his 3 years at Nebraska Kearney. Two balls and two strikes to Zach Douglas, the right-hander. Collins' pitch, just missed inside. Again, we're at a tough angle off to the right of home plate, so tough to tell, but it did look inside. At least Zach Douglas made it look that way. So now the count is full. Runner is second base. Don't want to walk this runner after getting the leadoff double down the third base line. Cameron Haynes is on deck. Blake checks second. Pitch is in the dirt. Good stop by Ayoub. And now Zach Douglas, who is, again, hitting 143 on the season, will walk. And he got ahead of Douglas 1-2, Collins did, but ends up walking him. So now all of a sudden there's 2-1 with nobody out for the 8, 9, and 1-hole hitters. Haynes struck out as he's playing in his first game of the summer. He just joined the Mudcats. This lineup is without a lot of regulars. They don't have Derek Rodrigo, Will Price, Billy Rockefeller, Thomas LaRouge, Jaden Eggleman. And three of those guys were All-Stars this year in the Mink League All-Star game a couple of weeks ago. But they are not in the lineup tonight. I'm not sure they're with the team. They may have left. And now Blake McFadden going to go talk to Blake Collins. Pitch was high for ball one to Cameron Haynes. Again, this is the bottom third of the order. And none of them with real impressive numbers so far. So you might want to just challenge these guys and see if they can hit it and let your defense help you. Haynes is 0-1 in his season, as he has not played until tonight, playing in his first game of the summer. That's what leads me to believe that some of the guys I just talked about are no longer with this team. They're trying to piece this together this final week of the regular season. And with their schedule, right as of right now, they have three games that they haven't played, but I don't think there's any intention of making those games up. So this is, I think, their last game of the season. Cameron Haynes swings right-handed. He struck out his first time up, the only strikeout for Blake Collin so far in the game. Here's the pitch. It is a called strike on the outside corner. 1-1. We'll see if Blake can come back. It's evened up 1-1. Runners at first and second. Their double play depth up the middle could use a double play. They've had two in their first four innings. 1-6-4-3 and one a line drive right back to Collins. Here's the 1-1 from Blake. Challenge him with a fastball, and he's swung through it. I'd be surprised if he doesn't challenge him with a fastball again here. Haynes looks a little bit out of rhythm. I don't think he's probably been playing anywhere else, so he hasn't played this summer. His timing probably a little bit off. 1-2 the count. Let's see if Blake can get a big strikeout here. The 9-hole hitter Gonzalez is on deck. Runners at first and second, nobody out. Now time is called by Cameron Haynes. Haynes plays at Ellsworth Community College. Lead off double and a walk. Creer at second, Douglas at first. Here's Blake's pitch. There goes the runner, and the pitch is high, and Ayoub's got no chance. High leg kick, and he didn't look back at second, so that time a huge, huge jump by Creer. He steals third base. That one was on Blake Collins and certainly was not Oh, and Max Ayoub didn't even have a chance to throw it. So Creer gets the stolen base. And that will be his fifth steal in five attempts. So not a guy that has a lot of stolen bases this year, but he got a humongous jump. And again, Ayoub couldn't even throw down to third base. They're going to stay back, give up a run for hopefully two outs if they can get a ground ball, but they could use a strikeout right here. It's a 2-2 count. The pitch, got him, swing and a miss. Big strikeout for Blake Collins. So two strikeouts for Collins, both up against Cameron Haynes. So now a ground ball can end the inning. Runners at first and third with one down. Isaac Gonzalez 0-for-1 in the game, and he grounded out to the shortstop, Jackson Schnurbusch, his first time up. They could use that right here for a 6-4-3. Runners at the corners, one out. A scoreless game in the bottom half of the fifth inning. Collins comes set. Fastball low and away for ball one. Keeping that runner at first base close to keep that double play. They don't want him to take off towards second. The runner, Douglas, on the season has not even attempted a stolen base. In his 3 years at Northwest Missouri State, he's also not attempted a stolen base. Ball low, though. Now it's a two-ball and no-strike count. Top of the order is on deck. Joey Morales is on deck for the Mudcats. Two balls and no strikes. Here's the pitch from Blake Collins, and he fouls it to the screen, off to the right side. It's a two ball and one strike count. Blake was at 53 pitches through four innings, but now it's on 18 here in the fifth. They were hoping to get him through seven or eight if they could, but this inning could have something to do with that. He's at 71 now. Here's the pitch. Fastball challenged him again. He lost his bat, and he fouls it back out of play. So Blake has come back to make it a two-ball and two-strike count. Trying to keep the ball low. He wants to induce a double play if he can, a ground ball at least. Corner infielders are even with the bags. Middle infielders at double play depth. The Mustangs scoreless right now with the Chillicothe Mudcats. Here's the 2-2 to Gonzalez. Ground ball towards Schnurbusch. He'll go to second for one. The turn by Houston is in time. 6-4-3 double play as Schnurbusch gets it to Houston. A great turn, and they get out of the inning. The third double play through five innings so far for the Mustangs. We're scoreless through five right here on ESPN 1550 and uClickTV.com.
Best for my family, and it seems we're always on the go. Whether it's to school, sports, church, no time is a good time for car trouble. To avoid trouble, I take my car to Walton Motors in Savannah. It's well worth the drive for the great service and peace of mind I receive. Whether it's an oil change, front alignment, brakes, tires, tune-up, or major service, I know I can trust the guys at Walton Motors Service in Savannah, where they've been taking care of families like yours and mine for three generations.
Walton in Savannah is where you'd send a friend.
The grass isn't going to cut itself. Make short work of it with a new Gravely mower from Horizon Outdoor. Zero turn starting at just $24.99 with 0% interest for 48 months and payments as low as $55 a month. No matter what size yard you have, whether it's residential or commercial, you'll find a Gravely that's perfect for the job. Stop by Horizon Outdoor and test drive one today. Gravely, an American workhorse since 1916.
Get your game on at the St. Joe Frontier Casino. Over 500 slots and high-intensity table games for fun and excitement. Great food at delicious prices in the River's Edge Cafe, Buffet, and Lounge. And more fun when you're an A-Play Club member.
Exclusive offers, comps, and free gifts.
The more you play, the more you win.
Get your game on
at the St. Joe Frontier Casino at the Highland Exit, number 7, off Interstate 229 in St. Joe. Must be 21.
Gambling problem? Call 1-888-BETS-OFF.
A new pitcher for the Chillicothe Mudcats as they will bring in Andrew Kuhlman to throw now for the Mudcats on the season. He is 3-2. This will be his 11th appearance. He's made six starts and five relief appearances now. He's thrown two complete games. He plays at Drury University, went to DeSmet High School in the St. Louis area. But 3-2 with a 3.07 ERA. In 41 innings, he's allowed just 32 hits. He struck out 16, but Much like a lot of the Mudcat pitchers, he has walked more batters than he struck out this year. So he's had some issues with that. He comes on to pitch here in the sixth in a scoreless game. Richardson a ground ball towards second. Gonzalez is right there. He'll throw out Jacob Richardson on a little bit high to first baseman Tyler Burns, but first pitch swinging was Richardson and a ground out. And when we talked to Coach Johnson in between the last half inning, he talked about trying to get his team some enthusiasm, get him going somehow, but again, if you can't get runners on base, it's hard to be creative and try and get some energy with hits and runs and different things like that, putting guys in motion. Leadoff man has been on base only one time now in six innings. Now it'll be Trent Hill and Ramsey Scott with one out as Jacob Richardson grounds out to Gonzalez. In the game, Trent is 0 for 2. He had two hits in last night's game, plus he had scored two runs, had two RBIs, and got a save. It was just another night at the office for Trent Hill last night in Sedalia, as he had a big one. Trent this year against Chillicothe pitching is 3 for 14 with an RBI. Now he looks at a curveball high, and it's a one ball, one strike count, as the first pitch was a called strike. So nobody has real great numbers against Chillicothe this year, and none of the Mudcats either. Likewise, they don't have great numbers against the Mustangs. Fly ball left field, going back is Douglas, and he'll make the catch. Two up, two down. Against Andrew Kuhlman. He's thrown four pitches to get two outs now as this game is flying by. Again, it started an hour late because of rain in the area throughout in the last week, but also they had some rain today. You can tell the field is very wet. They've done a pretty good job to get it ready, but it started an hour late because of the field conditions. Now it'll be Ramsey Scott with two down. See if he can get a spark going. First pitch he sees is high for ball number one. Ramsey leads this team with five homers, 33 RBI. He's 0 for 2 so far in the game. Ramsey, another one of the guys, has had a great year, but he's only 3 for 20 against Chillicothe pitching this season. Looks at one at the knees, maybe even a little bit below the knees, inside corner for strike number one. One ball, one strike to Ramsey Scott. Ramsey was out 6, threw in the ground out to the shortstop back in the fourth and flew out to center fielder Garrison Schwartz back in the second inning. Curveball, bounces it off the plate, off to the right side, out of play. Makes the count 1-2 with two down. Nobody on base for St. Joseph. No runs, two hits for both teams. The Mustangs do have one error in the game. Curveball got him. He swings and misses, and that will retire the side in order in the sixth. We go to the bottom half of the sixth. We are scoreless with the St. Joseph Mustangs and the Chillicothe Mudcats. This is Mustangs Baseball on ESPN 1550.
Group in St. Joseph provides total transportation solutions to truck owners who wish to balance quality products, services, and price. Summit has ASE certified technicians for warranty work on Caterpillar and Cummins engines, Allison transmissions, International and Workhorse products, MaxForce engines, and parts for all makes and models. For international parts and service needs, stop by Summit Truck Group in the Mitchell Woods Business Park, east of Riverside Road in St. Joseph. Summit Truck Group, a higher standard of value.
Rock Ridge Steel, the area's steel superstore in Elwood, Kansas, has steel for construction. Bars, beams, tubing, pipes, sheet, and plates. Steel for farms. Steel for DIY projects. Sunrooms, basements, and garages cut to your specifications. For a free estimate on the best price steel in Nebraska, Iowa, Missouri, and Kansas, call Dan Riley at 913-365-5200. That's Rock Ridge Steel. Rock solid steel. At rock bottom prices.
Hey guys, are you tired of feeling awkward and out of place when you go to get your hair cut? You don't have to anymore. Gentlemen, meet your new favorite chair at Knockouts. Simply walk in, help yourself to a beverage, and watch the game on the flat screens. Relax and feel the stresses of the day melt away with a complimentary scalp massage. You'll leave looking like the distinguished gentleman that you are. Knockouts, Knockouts, Knockouts. Haircuts and grooming for men behind UMB Bank on Belt and Frederick.
You're listening to St. Joe's Summer College Baseball Team. Oh, ESPN 1550.
Dave Rickard back in Chillicothe. Jim Bly with me this evening on uClickTV.com. And St. Joseph taking on Chillicothe, and we are scoreless through five and a half. We're at the bottom of the sixth inning. Both teams, no runs. Both teams, just two hits so far in the game. Blake Collins out for his sixth inning of work. He's thrown 73 pitches through five. First pitch of the sixth inning is a called strike and a fastball to the top of the order. Joey Morales will lead things up. Morales, Schwartz, and Remick, 1-2-3 for the Mudcats in a scoreless game in the sixth. Collins has thrown well. He's thrown a seven-inning complete game against Chillicothe this season. He squares to bunt. Morales does, but a called strike as he pulled it back. So a called strike, and Blake is ahead. No balls and two strikes to Morales. An 0-for-2 so far. His last time up, he flew out to the right fielder, Scott Barron, off the end of the bat. Morales on the season is just 1-for-10 against St. Joseph pitching with a walk. Ground ball wide of first base, foul ball. Late on a fastball. It stays no balls and two strikes. Leadoff batter is Morales here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Mudcats nothing to play for right now, just playing at the season as they are out of the race in the north. Curveball is out in front of that one. Lifts to left field. Lorenzo Fisher moves in one, maybe two steps, and he will reach up and make the grab in left field. So the first batter retired. Chillicothe had the leadoff man on in two of the first five innings, now two of the first six. Mustangs have only done it once in their first six times up. But Morales is now 0-for-3. Neither team with much life in this game. As Coach Johnson said, looks like a junior college game that he went recruiting on in the fall. I don't know if he was knocking junior colleges, but kind of seemed like that, although he has a lot of junior college players on his roster. There's a swing and a miss by Garrison Schwartz, who's 0-for-1. He walked and was doubled up in the first, and then was out 3-1 on the ground ball to Trent Hill in the fourth. No balls and a strike to the center fielder for the Mudcats. Wearing 26 after he's worn 13 most of the year. Pitch high, one ball, one strike. The Royals trail the Pirates 8-4 in the top of the seventh. Here's a pitch low. Two balls and a strike now to Garrison Schwartz. On the season, he's hitting .282, no homers and 13 RBI against the Mustangs this year. Schwartz is now 3-for-12, hitting just .250. He has an RBI, strikeout, and a walk. Ball low, now three balls and no strike. Two balls and a strike. No, excuse me, 3-1. I beg your pardon. So 3-1 the count to Schwartz as he bats left-handed with nobody on base and one down. John Remick on deck. He had a double back in the fourth inning, then was left at third base. Ooh, just missed right below the knees. He's had that call a couple of times. And that'll be a five-pitch walk after he got up 0-1. Max Ayub looks back at the home plate umpire and asks him where that ball was. And now one-on-one out for John Remick, who had a double to right center field his last time up. Remick plays at the University of Kansas as he is a Jayhawk. He'll be a junior. He is from San Diego. I didn't realize there was a Torrey Pines High School. Obviously, no, most people know about Torrey Pines, the golf course. So we're going to miss on a fastball here. But he went to Torrey Pines High School. I'm guessing since it's in San Diego and it's Torrey Pines, I'm guessing it's pretty nice. 0-1 the count to Remick. Collins now at 82 pitches, making it 83 pitches here in the sixth inning. Collins' fastball, challenged him again. It's fouled off the glove of Ayub, and now it's no balls and two strikes. So he gets ahead of Remick, the catcher, who was an all-star this past season. He played and he started on the North squad in the all-star game a couple of Thursdays ago inside Phil Welch. No balls and two strikes, one out. Schwartz at first base for Chillicothe. Tries a curveball and missed low. Now one ball, two strikes. Remick 1-for-2 in the game against the Mustangs this season. Remick is now 3-for-12. He has struck out once and walked twice. There goes the runner. He got a good jump, but a foul ball back to the screen will keep him at first base. One thing, Blake, he's a left-hander, and even at third base, when they stole third, he has a high leg kick still when he goes from the stretch. He has a high leg kick. If you can time it right, you can get a pretty good jump on Collins. He still has the high leg kick. That one was not quite as high. He tries a off-speed pitch that misses high and away. Wasn't quite a slide step, but it was kind of in between his high leg kick and a slide step. 2-2 after it was 0-2. Remick, a good AB. Again, one for two. He has one of the two base hits, a double for the Mudcats. And a throw to first base, just a sop toss. Trent Hill playing first tonight as Ramsey Scott's the DH. Jerry Houston's at second. Jackson Schnurbusch at short. And Josh Cassidy at third base. Orencio Fisher's in left tonight. Jacob Richardson is in center. And Scott Burns in right. There goes a runner and a fastball. Swing and a miss. Throw down to second. No chance again. Got a big jump. Ayub, a good throw on one hop, but no chance to get him. So they get the strikeout. There's two down. Third K in the game for Collins, but Schwartz steals the bag, and now he's in scoring position. That brings up a dangerous hitter in Josh Ethier. And now Blake McFadden going to make his way out to the mound. So he will go talk to Collins. Collins now at 88 pitches through 5 2/3. Going to bring the entire infield in. Again, the Mudcats have swiped a couple of bags pretty easily on Collins with a high leg kick. But McFadden will talk to the entire infield now with a runner at second base and two down. We are in a scoreless game in the bottom half of the sixth inning. These two teams meeting for the sixth and final time here in the regular season. Mudcats have won three. The Mustangs have won two. St. Joseph trying to even up the season series. Josh Ether is the batter now. The right-handed third baseman is 0-2 so far in the game. A ground out to Collins his last time up and then reaching an error by Jackson Schnurbusch back in the second, a ground ball to Mustang shortstop. Two outs, runner at second base. It was a one-out walk to Schwartz, then he swiped the bag on the strikeout of Remick. Ethier hitting .309 on the season. One home run, 14 RBI from Tempe, Arizona. He plays at Central Arizona College. Here's Collins' first pitch. It is low for ball one. On deck is Tyler Burns, .247 hitter, so we'll see if they try and be careful with Ether, who, again, has a better average. He's in the cleanup spot for this team tonight. Ether is just 2-for-12 this season against St. Joseph pitching. Runner stays put, pitches low and away. So far, Burns, who is 0-for-2 in the game, he's 1-for-7 against Mustang pitching and also had a chance earlier in this game with a runner at third base and two outs, and he grounded out to Collins. So let's see if they're careful with Ethier here. Runner at second in a scoreless game, two down. Misses high and away. I think he's trying to be pretty careful with Ethier. Burns is on deck. And also certainly makes it easier with a force at second base as well on a ground ball up the middle. Collins has walked four so far in the game with three strikeouts, but only two hits allowed. Now a four-pitch walk, so being very careful with Ethier. They're going to put him on base. And now there will be runners at first and second for Tyler Burns. Burns had a chance his last time over with a runner at third base and two outs, but he grounded out to Collins. Another opportunity with a man in scoring position. 2-1, two out in a scoreless game here in inning number six. Blake Collins now at 92 pitches. He's thrown 40 pitches now the last two innings. I must have jinxed him talking about how long they wanted to go with Collins, as they said 7 or 8 if they could. And they've got a game tomorrow at Nevada. Then a day off, and then they get Sedalia Thursday. Pitch is low. There's five consecutive balls thrown by Blake Collins. So five walks in the game. That's got him into some trouble, but still only getting no runs for Chillicothe. And only the two hits so far in the game. There's also been an error, so there have been plenty of runners for the Mudcats, but no runs to show for it yet. Trying to keep it that way with two down here in the sixth. Collins from the stretch, checks second. Here's the pitch home. Missed inside. There's six consecutive balls thrown by Collins. And there is action in the bullpen. The bullpen is right next to the dugout, so they're all together here in Chillicothe. Two balls and no strikes to Tyler Burns, who is 0-for-2 in the game. Ground out to Collins and a pop-up on the infield to Jerry Houston at second base. Now he hits one deep to right center field. Richardson on the run will run it down in the alley deep in right center field, and that will end the inning and leave two more on base as the St. Joseph Mustangs' Blake Collins works around 2-on, 2-out, and he gets the long fly ball to right center field. That ends the inning. We are through six. The St. Joseph Mustangs are scoreless with the Chillicothe Mudcats right here on ESPN 1550.
Visit Horizon Equipment, your local John Deere dealer. They're just a few miles east of St. Joseph on 36 Highway, and they have a wide selection of John Deere riding mowers, zero-turn mowers, and garden tractors. Let their professionals help fit you to the right equipment for your job. They also have a top-notch John Deere parts and service department, and if you want it to run like a Deere, it has to be a Deere. Give them a call today and find out about discounts and financing options. You'll find a full line of John Deere at Horizon Equipment at Route C and 36 Highways, just east of St. Joseph.
It takes hard work and dedication to have a winning team. The Mustangs showed us this last season. And here at the new Anderson Ford, we share the same commitment to our customers. Whether it's sales or service, the new Anderson Ford will serve your needs by always doing what is right. Stop by and check out the new Anderson Ford, 2207 North Belt Highway.
Anderson Ford, your regional Ford superstore. Online at AndersonAutoGroup.com.
It's one of the busiest times of the year to buy and sell real estate in Northwest Missouri. So Mustangs fans, step up to the plate and hit a home run when you choose Reese Nichols Eye Capital Realty to be part of your team. From new construction homes to townhomes, investment properties, commercial listings, and more, we've got all the bases covered. Why choose us for your real estate journey? Our agents, our expertise, our partners. Call Reese Nichols Eye Capital Realty today. We must be doing something right.
You're listening to St. Joseph Mustangs Baseball on ESPN, ESPN 1550.
Josh Cassidy will lead things off for the Mustangs here in the seventh. We are scoreless. No score between the Mustangs and Mudcats here in Chillicothe. I am Dave Riggert. It will be 5-6-7 for St. Joe's Summer College baseball team against Andrew Kuhlman, who had an 8-pitch inning, his last inning of work as he's into his second frame. First pitch that he throws is inside for ball one to Josh Cassidy. Josh so far in the game is 1-for-1. He singled up the middle with two outs in the fourth inning and then walked and was stranded back in the second. So Josh 1-for-1 so far in the contest. Came in hitting .281 with no homers and 21 RBI. Ground ball toward third. Ethier gloves it, goes to first base in time, and two pitches, one out on a ground ball to third base. Again, they cannot get that leadoff man on base. One time now in seven innings. On the ground ball by Ethier. Thank you. Kuhlman has four outs on 10 pitches now in his inning and a third. Scott Brown will bat left-handed. He gets a strike and the ball goes to the backstop as the two were not on the same page. Kuhlman and Remick as the ball went right to the backstop. He thought it was going to break, I believe, and it was a called strike. And now one of the Mustangs just got warned. I think it was Blake Collins. Said the kid with the water bottle, and I believe it's Blake Collins who just got warned on the Mustang bench. That seems to happen every time the Mustangs play here. Seems like there's bad blood between the teams and sometimes the umpires when they play in Chillicothe. So called strike, this one's high. One ball, one strike, the count. Scott's 0-for-2 so far in the game. Brarin against the Mudcats is 2-for-10 this season. One RBI, one run scored. Curve ball and a bouncing ball towards second. Should be an easy play for Gonzalez. He'll throw him out. 4-3 ground out as the Mustangs have now been retired six consecutive times. 5 in a row by Kuhlman, who came on in the sixth inning. But a 4-3 ground out here, and boy, this game's moving along, and there's not much excitement to it. No runs and two hits for both clubs. Just been one error in the game by Mustang shortstop Jackson Schnurbusch. See if Max Ayoub can do what he did at Nebraska Kearney and hit one of the long balls that he hit at UNK. 33 in 3 years, 17 as a senior. Looking for his first hit, takes a big swing there and misses as he has a one ball and one strike count. He is due. He's 0-for-1 in the game, 0-for-9 in the Mustang uniform as they picked him up when Brett Bond went to the Cape. As he got called by a Cape Cod team, and he is out there in the Cape Cod League. In the dirt, now two balls and a strike to Max Ayoub. I got to see Ayoub play for the Lopers when they came to Griffin Park, as Buzz Verduzco calls it, at Missouri Western. He had a good series, and he had getting out a great year. He had a great career at Nebraska Kearney, now missed inside. Three balls and a strike. Jerry Houston waits on deck. Mustangs try to get a two-out rally going with Ayub, a 3-1 count. Let's see if he gets a good pitch to hit right here. It's 220 on the left field line. 375 of the power alleys, and now a ball high. That's one thing Ayub has had a good eye. He's had a good eye. He's walked now three times in the four games that he's played in. He's walked twice now in this game. And a two-out walk. Let's see if the Mustangs can take advantage of that. Jerry Houston had two hits in RBI, drove in the game-winning run in the 10th inning of last night's game at Sedalia. And now to be Jackson Schnurbusch waiting on deck as he hopes to have an opportunity with two down. Ayub has not attempted a stolen base. He had three in three attempts. In his three-year career at UNK, he had 10 steals in 12 attempts. So he had a good ratio, didn't steal a lot. Now Houston tries to bunt for a base hit with two down. He bunts it foul down the first base line. The Royals are climbing back. They're within 8-6 now in the seventh inning against the Pirates. The Cardinal fan next to me is probably hoping for a Royals comeback. Gain a half game tonight with an off night for St. Louis. Matt Tritton, I'm speaking of. Although he's a Royals fan too. Not really, but he has to say he is. No balls and a strike with two down to Jerry Houston. He swings it right-handed. Fly ball to shallow left field. Going out the shortstop, Morales. He will make the catch in shallow left field, and that retires the Mustangs. As the two-out walk does not hurt Chillicothe. It's stretch time here in Chillicothe. No score between the Mustangs and the Chillicothe Mudcats. As we continue with St. Joseph Mustangs baseball right here on ESPN 1550 and uClickTV.com.
Equipment in Savannah is your source for lawn and garden equipment. They've got the complete lineup of Woods mowers, Kubota utility mowers and tractors, Cub Cadet mowers, and Land Pride equipment attachments. Everything you need to keep your lawn and garden looking great all year long. Dürr Equipment is here to help, from commercial to residential. Dürr has the lawn care equipment you need. Stop by Dürr Equipment for your lawn and garden equipment on Highway 71 north of Savannah.
Have you been to the Ground Round lately? It's where there's always a fusion of flavor. You'll find just what you're looking for.
Your favorite half-price appetizers, Monday through Friday, outrageous nachos, chicken quesadilla, spinach artichoke dip, and much more.
The Ground Round has the best daily happy hour from 3 to 6 p.m. and 9 p.m. to close, offering 15 flavors of Long Island iced teas. Good friends, good times, great food. See what's new at the historic downtown Ground Round on the corner of 6th and Edmond. What you like, Ground Round.
Today's Mustang game is brought to you in part by Duval Lawn Care Incorporated. Do you have unsightly weeds in your lawn? Do you want a greener, richer looking lawn? Then give Duval Lawn Care a call. Duval Lawn Care serves commercial and residential customers in St. Joseph, North Kansas City, and the surrounding area. For a personalized proposal and a great looking lawn, give the folks at Duval Lawn Care a call at 816-662-2222. That's 662-2222.
This is St. Joseph Mustangs Baseball, ESPN 1550.
We continue from Chillicothe tonight as the St. Joseph Mustangs and Chillicothe Mudcats in a pitcher's duel. Only four hits combined through six and a half innings. Each team has two hits so far, no runs to speak of. And we continue as the Mudcats will have 6-7-8 up. Aaron Creer will bat now for the Mudcats. He has one of the two base hits. He singled his last time up. He doubled. Both hits have been doubles for the Mudcats. He doubled down the third baseline and was left at third base. Off the glove of Josh Cassidy, trickled in left field. And Logan Jasek is the new pitcher for the Mustangs, as he pitched in last night's game and gave up two runs in the seventh inning to tie that game at five. So Jasek going to throw in consecutive innings. So Logan Jasek on to pitch now, a check swing foul off to the right side. A ball and a called strike. One ball, one strike the count. No score here in the bottom of inning number seven. Cryer plays at Wayne State College from Storm Lake High School in Iowa. Logan Jasek last night gave up a couple of runs. He walked two in his one inning of work. He did come out for the eighth inning and then walked his first batter in the eighth inning last night as well. So he didn't have a great outing. His outing before that was the previous Sunday in a loss to Sedalia. So Logan has struggled here lately, but he comes on here, bunt attempt, and now it's going to be a two-ball and two-strike count. They're trying to save the bullpen as they threw a lot the last few days. That's why they had to throw Aspie 2 1/3 last night, and then Trent Hill came on to get the last two outs of the game to get the save. Jasek threw one-plus innings last night as he threw the seventh and came on in the eighth. But it walked the first batter that he faced before Aspirin came on. Fastball challenge him, and a ground ball, a high hop for Cassie. Charges, throws to first base, and got him by a step. Cryer runs well, but a good play by Josh Cassie and a high hopper to third base. So Cassie will throw him out, and there's the first out. Leadoff man retired here in the seventh by Logan Jasek. Mitch Steinhoff, who has been a starter all year long, has never come out of the pen this season. 2-2, a 3.89 ERA, is warming up in the pen. That's who they would have probably had to go to last night had the game continued and gone 11, 12 innings. They probably would have gone to Mitch Steinhoff. Here's the pitch by Jasek and a swing and a miss by Zach Douglas. Douglas walked and he was doubled up his last time up on a ground ball by Gonzalez to close out the fifth when they had runners at first and third and one out. So Jasek has been fairly sharp so far in this inning. There's a called strike. He's ahead 0-2. Logan looked pretty good early in the year, but has a 6.29 ERA right now. He's 1-3. This is his third relief appearance and now pitching in back-to-back games. Again, Coach Johnson said the bullpen is rested. And now a line drive to left field coming out as Orencio Fisher, and he will make the catch on the run. But it might get down in front of him, but Orencio got a good jump. He gets the out, and Logan Jasek retires the first two men that he faces here in the seventh inning. So two up, two down. And again, with the scoreless game, if it's a close game, I'm guessing their normal bullpen guys would probably come in. But the way this game is going, it could take a little while. Cardinals and Mets played an 18-inning affair that didn't score until, the 12th that game, 13th? And then it ended up being a 3-1 win for the Mets last night or yesterday afternoon that turned into last night. Inside bush thing. Yeah, I just made this an 18-inning game all of a sudden. I'm sorry. There's a called strike from Jasek to Cameron Haynes, who's 0-2 with two strikeouts. Out in front of that one, now it's a 0-2 count. So Jasek, boy, it's a different pitcher than what we saw on last night. He couldn't throw a strike for a few batters that he faced. Looks pretty confident right now and has an 0-2 count against Cameron Haynes, the DH. Again, he struck out twice against Blake Collins. We're in the bottom of the seventh with no runs on the scoreboard. There's a pitch up and in. Jasek at 11 pitches now here in this frame. Haynes playing in his first game this summer with the Mudcats. He bats right-handed. Jasek peeks in, gets the sign from Max Ayoub, the catcher. He wants it low. Kept it low, but a little bit too far. 2-2 the count. Two outs, nobody on base for the Mudcats in a scoreless game in the seventh inning. And this game began an hour late because of field conditions, very wet. They've had a lot of rain around here, had some today. Here's the 2-2. Challenge him, and a fastball is going to be fouled off down the first base line. 2-2 count. Goes through the legs of the first base coach and assistant coach Wally Marcial. Made a good one-handed play earlier, and the Mustang dugout razzes him a little bit. Mudcats have had more base runners, but nothing to show for it yet. Still a 2-2 count to Haynes. Called strike three outside corner. Gets the strikeout, the fourth by Mustang pitching, and Logan Jasek throws a perfect seventh inning. We go to the eighth through seven. We are scoreless between the Mustangs and the Mudcats right here on ESPN 1550.
Summer's here. It's time to get back out and enjoy the yard, especially for your dog. Now is the perfect time to address fleas and ticks before you have a big problem on your hands. Countryside Veterinary Clinic in St. Joe is ready to make the fight easier than ever with NexGard. This soft beef-flavored chewable treat kills both fleas and ticks for a full 30 days. Fleas and ticks hate it, vets recommend it, and your dog will be begging for it. Visit Countryside Veterinary Clinic today and make sure your whole family is ready to enjoy the outdoors this
season.
Hi, this is Aaron from Lanham Music, and most people know us for our great selection of instruments at prices that meet or beat the big internet stores. We also have a dedicated sound technician to install or service systems for churches, businesses, and schools. We have the most comprehensive lesson program in the area, offering recording classes, rock camp, and private instruction on over a dozen instruments. Find us at 2401 North Belt Highway or online at lanhammusic.com. Lanham Music, personal service from local musicians.
Surprising savings are coming to Missouri with the KCP&L Home Energy Rebate Show.
What am I going to do with this second fridge?
Did I hear you say second refrigerator?
Yes, but how did you?
Not important. I'll give you $75 for it through KCP&L Home Energy Rebates.
Wow, that's great. But what about...
I'll even take it away for free. Don't know what to say? I get that all the time.
See why it pays to save energy. Visit kcpl.com/save today.
You're listening to St. Joseph Mustangs Baseball on ESPN 1550.
Dave Rickard back in Chillicothe. Jim Bly with me on uClickTV.com as the St. Joseph Mustangs right now are scoreless with the Chillicothe Mudcats. It'll be Jackson Schnurbusch to lead things off. 9-1-2 for St. Joseph here in the top of the eighth inning. It's Andrew Kuhlman, who has retired six of the seven he's faced in the last two innings, only 20 pitches. So he has thrown very well in relief. The third pitcher for the Mudcats out for the eighth inning. And his third inning of work, first pitch that Jackson Schnurbusch sees is high and inside. Now it's inside in a two-ball count to Jackson Schnurbusch. He has one of the two base hits, a line drive back up the middle. That came back in the third inning. Then he was picked off first base. He also was out on a 6-3 ground out to the shortstop, Joey Morales. So 1-for-2 in the game. Here's the pitch by Kuhlman. Low and inside. Three balls and no strikes. So in danger of walking in the nine-hole hitter for the top of this Mustang lineup. Lorenzo Fisher waits on deck. And then Jacob Richardson, there's a called strike, was taking the entire way, make him throw a strike. On the season, Kuhlman has walked more than he has struck out. He has 1K through 2-plus innings now, has not walked a batter yet. Again, has retired 6 of 7. Oh, it hit him. So that will be a hit by pitch. It won't go as a walk, but it will go as a free base, and it's a hit by pitch. Leadoff man on for just the second time now in 8 innings. St. Joseph Mustangs now have their leadoff man on here in inning number 8 for the top of the order. We'll see if they play small ball now or if they try hit and run something creative, as, again, there is no life in this game at all. And the Mustangs pump some life into this game here in the top of the 8th inning. Leadoff man on for just the second time now in the 8 ABs that they have had. They have a meeting at the mound right now as Wally Marcial, the assistant coach for the Mudcats, out to talk. Josh Ethier, the third baseman, comes over, as does the catcher, John Remick. No score, only 4 hits through 7 complete innings. 2 for each club. 2 doubles for Chillicothe. A couple of singles for the Mustangs. As Schnurbusch has one and Cassidy has one. And now Arencio Fisher, who is 0 for 3, digs in. He was out 1-3 his last time up on a ground ball to the pitcher. Struck out swinging in the third and flew out to center in the first. 0 on his 21st birthday. See if he can keep things going. He squares to bunt, gets it down the first base line. He will try and hustle, and an underhand throw gets him by a step. So he gets the sacrifice bunt down. He does his job, gets the runner in a scoring position for Jacob Richardson. So they play small ball here in this contest with no runs so far in this game. Good bunt by Arencio gets Schnurbusch down to second base. That'll bring up Jacob Richardson. Also 0 for 3 in the game. Against the Mudcats this season, Jake is 3 of 14 with 4 strikeouts. He struck out once in this game. The pitch to Richardson is low for ball 1 from Kuhlman. Andrew Kuhlman, the third pitcher, threw 2 1/3. On the season, a good year, 3-2. He's been a starter and a reliever. 3.07 ERA. Can they get to him here this third inning of work? And now a fly ball deep to right field. Going back is Cryer, and he will not get there. It's to the wall. Scoring easily is Schnurbusch, and the St. Joseph Mustangs get a triple from Jacob Richardson, a stand-up triple, and the St. Joseph Mustangs break through here in the eighth inning as Richardson drives in his 22nd run of the year, and the Mustangs lead 1-0. Their first extra base hit, just their third hit in the game, and a triple to deep right center that Cryer and Schwartz could not get to. Richardson gets the RBI, and a leadoff hit by pitch comes back to hurt Andrew Kuhlman and the Mudcats. Mustangs finally break through here in the eighth. 1-0 St. Joseph. And again, a win tonight. Looks like it will clinch the Mink League North Division Championship. They'll win the Mink League North for the fourth time in their 7 years of existence. Every time they have won their North Division Championship, they've won a Mink League title as well. And now a pitch in the dirt. Richardson was going to break for home, but a good block by John Remick behind the plate. Pitches in the dirt for ball one to Trent Hill, who is 0-3. Trent flew out to left his last time up. Earlier in the game, had a 3-1 ground out to the first baseman Burns, and then was out 4-3 on a ground ball to Gonzalez at second base. Kuhlman checks third base where Richardson is. Pitches high for a two-ball count now to Trent Hill. He is way ahead in the count as they try and add to their 1-0 lead. Runner at third base, one out. One run in on a triple by Jacob Richardson. Trent drove in two in last night's event victory. Curveball high. Ramsey Scott is on deck. They might be trying to be very careful with Hill, as hot as he has been. Put him on first base and take your chances with Ramsey. At least give yourself an opportunity for a ground ball and a double play. Kuhlman's pitch, not going to give him anything in a four-pitch walk. So they're very careful with Trent Hill, and rightfully so, the way he's been swinging the bat. Came in hitting 344. And now it's up to Ramsey Scott with one down to try and get that runner home from third base. A two-run lead in this game seems like about a five-run lead. They've got a one-run lead right now. A one-out triple by Jacob Richardson, the score Jackson Schnurbusch, as he led off the inning with a hit by pitch.
Give it a ride.
Ramsey Scott 0-3 in the game. His last time up, he struck out. Third first base is not in time. Trent's not going anywhere, I doubt it. He is 1-for-3 on steal attempts this season. He was 7-for-10, though, at Lee University this past year. Kuhlman's pitch, and Ramsey takes a big swing and fouls it away back behind home plate.
Don't forget, fans, half price.
No balls and a strike.
Well,
one out. Price. Mustangs with runners at the corners and one in already. They lead 1-0 here in the top of the eighth inning. Ramsey is only this season 3-for-21 against Mudcat pitching. Kuhlman comes, set the pitch home. Just missed below the knees inside, and it's a ball. One ball, one strike. One out here in the eighth inning. Mustangs trying to wrap up the Mink League North. Kuhlman comes set again. There goes Trent Hill, and it's a pitch low and inside. Going to fake the throw down to second base. Trent got a good jump. I think he would have stole that base with a throw even. But Richardson and his speed at third base force a non-throw, and now there's two in scoring position with one out, and that will eliminate the ground ball double play. It's a two ball and one strike count as that pitch missed. But a stolen base for Trent Hill, his second of the season. Kuhlman's pitch and fouled back. Good swing again by Ramsey Scott. He just missed it. Two balls, two strikes, one out. Two in scoring position for the Mustangs RBI leader as he has 33 on the season. Ramsey bats left-handed. Kuhlman checks second base. Trent Hill a big lead. Now the infield comes in, and Ramsey Scott strikes out on an off-speed pitch as he swings and misses, and that is a huge strikeout. The infield had come in when Hill got to second base, and Ramsey could not put the bat on the ball. Well, that's a big out for Andrew Kuhlman. And now it's up to Cassidy with two down now as Josh is 1-for-2 in the contest. 1-0 St. Joseph, but again, had a great chance with two in scoring position and one out. Ramsey has struck out for the second time in the game. 0-for-4 now and just 3-for-22 against the Mudcats this season. Cassidy now pops it up into foul territory over by the Mustang dugout. It will stay in play, and that will be a misplay by the first baseman Burns. He had some room but could not make the catch. So another life for Josh Cassidy on a foul ball that the first baseman Burns couldn't get to. He got to, just didn't play it very well. So Casty will have another chance. He is 1-for-2 in the game, has a base hit that came back in inning number 4. Two outs, single up the middle. Walked in the second, so he's been on base twice. And he had a 5-3 ground out to the third baseman, Ethier, back to start the seventh inning. He bats right-handed with Scott Brerin on deck. Here's the pitch from Kuhlman. In the dirt, good stop by Remick. He's a very good defensive catcher. Again, he was named the Mink League All-Star this season on the North squad. One ball, one strike. Kuhlman threw 20 pitches to get 6 outs in the first 2 innings of work. He has thrown now, this will be his 20th pitch here in this frame. But, again, trying to limit the damage, just one run allowed. It could be much worse. The pitch popped him up, foul out of play off to the right side. As it sneaks over the Mustang dugout, and they occupy the one down the first baseline this evening, which they do every game. Every game they play, they're in the first base dugout. I didn't realize that until Coach Johnson mentioned that to Preston Felgate when I was in the dugout for that game earlier in the season. Every road game, they're in the first base, and obviously at home, they're down the first baseline. 1-2 the count to Josh Cassidy. Up and in, 2-2. Josh, again, was red hot in the middle part of this year. He's cooled off a little bit, still hitting .281. No homers, 21 RBI. He bats right-handed. Here's the righty's pitch from Kuhlman. He swings and fouls it away. Good at-bat against Andrew Kuhlman. Making him work now. Stays 2 balls and 2 strikes. This will be the 7th pitch of the at-bat. Josh Cassidy digs back in. Richardson at third base. Trent Hill's at second. Richardson the triple that scored Schnurbush, and then the walk to Hill. He stole second base. A strikeout of Ramsey Scott. Put another out on the scoreboard. Now it's up to Josh Cassidy with a 2-2 count. Curveball. He hangs off it. Gets away from Remick, and that will score Richardson easy. So the Mustangs take a 2-0 lead on a wild pitch, as John Remick could not keep that one in front of him, and the Mustangs get an easy run that way as Richardson will score on the wild pitch. Tried a curveball, and again, Remick's a great defensive catcher. Could not stop that one. It got behind him, and Richardson scored easily. 2-0 St. Joseph here in the 8th. Now they'll try and get a third run as Cassidy has a 3-2 count. Here's the pitch, and a line drive to left center field, hit very well. Going back is Douglas. He won't get to it. It is off the wall. Cassidy drives in a run. He's around second base and will stay put right there as Josh Cassidy, a 2-out double, gives the Mustangs a 3-0 lead as they put 3 up here in the top of inning number 8, and a 2-out RBI for Josh. It's his 2nd hit in the game and his 22nd RBI this season. 3-0 Mustangs here in the top of the 8th. He hammered that ball, line drive to left field that was off the wall. But a double, and again, he wishes there wouldn't have been a wild pitch. He could have had 2 RBIs instead of just the 1, but he does make it 3-0. So the Mustangs have broken through, and these are 2 big extra runs. 2 runs with 2 outs. And now Scott Brerin go back to second base and getting the ball away from second base. Cassidy almost advanced to third base as Remick threw down to second. It was one hopped into the outfield, but Cassidy stayed put at second. Pitch was a ball, so it's 1 ball, no strikes. So Kuhlman, a rough inning, 25 pitches now. He had 20 the first 2 innings he threw. And now Scott Brerin is due. He's 0-for-3 in the game. He's 2-for-11 against the Mudcats this season. Fastball, good swing that time, and he fouls it back. Boy, lefties, when they take a good swing, it looks pretty. Scott had a great swing that time, just missed it. 1 ball, 1 strike, 2 down. Another man in scoring position. A 2-out double by Josh Cassidy. Curveball in the dirt, gets away. Remick kicked it himself and kept it in front of him. Good job by John Remick. 2 balls and a strike. Andrew Kuhlman, the third pitcher for the Mudcats, and now in line for a loss. Mustangs are 6 outs away. Cassidy with that RBI. It's his 2nd against Mudcat pitching. He's now 6-for-18, .333 against the Mudcats this season. There goes a runner. Cassidy to third base. Throw down is in time. Got him. Great throw by Remick as Brarin looked at ball number three, I believe it was, and it will be a caught stealing by Josh Cassidy, but he drives in a big run. The Mustangs score three in the top of the eighth inning, and they lead 3-0 over Chillicothe as we continue with St. Joseph Mustangs baseball right here on ESPN 1550 and uClickTV.com.
Nowadays, Ford dealers all have the same factory incentives, programs, rebates, and interest rates. What the majority of dealers don't have is Walton Ford's experience. Walton Ford in Savannah has been serving Northwest Missouri for over three decades. The outstanding service you get is the reason why generations of the same family continue to buy their vehicles from Walton's. Skip the big dealership runaround and head to Walton Ford in Savannah. Check them out online at WaltonMotorsInc.com.
Walton in Savannah. Where you'd send a friend.
The grass isn't going to cut itself. Make short work of it with a new Gravely Mower from Horizon Outdoor. Zero turn starting at just $24.99 with 0% interest for 48 months and payments as low as $55 a month. No matter what size yard you have, whether it's residential or commercial, you'll find a Gravely that's perfect for the job. Stop by Horizon Outdoor and test drive one today. Gravely, an American workhorse since 1916.
Get your game on at the St. Joe Frontier Casino. Over 500 slots and high-intensity table games for fun and excitement. Great food at delicious prices in the River's Edge Cafe, Buffet, and Lounge. And more fun when you're an A-Play Club member. Exclusive offers, comps, and free gifts. The more you play, the more you win. Get your game on at the St. Joe Frontier Casino at the Highland Exit, number 7, off Interstate 229 in St. Joe. Must be 21.
Gambling problem? Call 1-888-BETS-OFF.
It's 9-1-2 for the Mudcats as they try and rally now in the eighth inning. They trail 3-0. Logan Jasek back out for a second inning of work, and he's in line for now his second win of the summer. As he came on to pitch the seventh inning, pitched a perfect 1-2-3 seventh. The Mustang offense came through with three in the top of the eighth, and they lead 3-0 now. As we continue from Schaefer Stadium in Chillicothe, now a line drive to right field, base hit. Leadoff single by the nine-hole hitter against Logan Jasek. As again, he's thrown well, but gives up a leadoff single and for the third time in eight innings now. Leadoff man is on for Chillicothe. 3-0 lead for the Mustangs, and back to the top of the order now for Chillicothe. Joey Morales will dig in now for the Mudcats. Morales is 0-for-3 in this game. On the season against the Mustangs, Morales is now 1-for-11. There goes a runner, and a line drive going to be caught by Jerry Houston. He'll throw to first base for a double play, and the Mustangs eliminate the leadoff single with their fourth double play of the night. And now there are two outs here in the bottom of the eighth inning on just three pitches after the leadoff single. But just like that, that's the game of baseball. Covering, boy, if Houston's covering, that's a base hit. Runners first and third, nobody out, but he wasn't covering. Schnurbusch was on the hit and run, and he lined it right to Jerry Houston. A break for the Mustangs, but that's the way baseball is sometimes. And it's a game of inches, and he is doubled off. Gonzalez is. And the Mustangs now four outs away from a victory here on the road and clinching the Mink League North Division Championship and playing in the Mink League Championship game coming up later this week. And Logan Jasek, I'm going to give him a lot of credit. He did not get off to good starts in any of his batters that he faced last night, but he has thrown first pitch strikes now to five of the six men that he has faced in this game. So he's getting off to good starts, getting ahead of batters. He has more confidence, it looks like, in this game than what he had last night. He gave up the two runs in the seventh to tie the game at five in last night's game. From the stretch is Jasek. There's a called strike, and now he's ahead one ball and two strikes and one strike away from getting out of the inning. Garrison Schwartz is 0-for-1. He walked and stole a base in the sixth. He was out 3-1 in the fourth and also walked in the first. So he's been on base twice. Here's the pitch from Jasek. Missed low and away, 2-2 the count. And Logan has limited his pitch count as well. That's 21 now, almost through two innings. He's in line for the win. We'll see what they do with in the ninth if they can keep this 3-0 lead. It'd be a save situation depending on what the Mustangs do in the top of the ninth, but they went with Trent Hill last night. Do they keep Jasek out and just go three innings and save the bullpen the rest of the week? Now Matt Johnson's going to go out with a 2-2 count, two outs, and nobody on base. Coach Johnson going to go out, and we don't see that very often. And it might be a little bit of an injury. I think Jacek, he might have tweaked something on that last pitch, so that's the issue now. Jacek says he's fine. And Matt Johnson will say, okay, keep it going. So he goes out there for one word. Jacek nodded and said yes, and he comes out. Matt does. He walks back to the dugout. Base is empty, two outs. Leadoff single was erased with a double play on a line drive, the fourth double play turned by the Mustangs tonight. Jacek's pitch, ooh, just missed outside. So now it's full 3-2. Again, you'd like Remick to lead off the ninth inning and not have a batter on base, a runner on base with now here. Line drive left field. That will get down for a base hit. Arencio Fisher playing deep will hold him to a single. Or no, he's going to try for two, and he gets gunned down at second base by Arencio Fisher as he made a just horrible base running decision. They need base runners, not a runner in scoring position. He gets gunned down by Arencio Fisher at second base trying to extend a single to a double. And the Mustangs, despite giving up two hits, retire the Mudcats in the minimum. Just three batters they saw in the inning. At the end of eight, St. Joseph right now leads Chillicothe by a score of 3-0 right here on ESPN 1550 and uclicktv.com.
Summit Truck Group in St. Joseph provides total transportation solutions to truck owners who wish to balance quality products, services, and price. Summit has ASE certified technicians for warranty work on Caterpillar and Cummins engines, Allison transmissions, International and Workhorse products, MaxForce engines, and parts for all makes and models. For international parts and service needs, stop by Summit Truck Group in the Mitchell Woods Business Park, east of Riverside Road in St. Joseph. Summit Truck Group, a higher standard of value.
Rock Ridge Steel, the area's steel superstore in Elwood, Kansas, has steel for construction. Bars, beams, tubing, pipes, sheet, and plates. Steel for farms. Steel for DIY projects. Sunrooms, basements, and garages, cut to your specifications. For a free estimate on the best priced steel in Nebraska, Iowa, Missouri, and Kansas, call Dan Riley at 913-365-5200. That's Rock Ridge Steel. Rock solid steel. At rock bottom prices.
Hey guys, are you tired of feeling awkward and out of place when you go to get your hair cut? You don't have to anymore. Gentlemen, meet your new favorite chair at Knockouts. Simply walk in, help yourself to a beverage, and watch the game on the flat screens. Relax and feel the stresses of the day melt away with a complimentary scalp massage. You'll leave looking like the distinguished gentleman that you are. Knockouts, Knockouts, Knockouts. Haircuts and grooming for men behind UMB Bank on Belt and Frederick.
You're listening to the St. Joseph Mustang. On ESPN 1550.
Dave Rigger back in Chillicothe. Thanks for joining us for Mustangs Baseball in St. Joseph. Now three outs away from winning the Mink League North Championship for the fourth time in 7 years. Fourth time in 5 years, as a matter of fact. Didn't win it the first 2 years, but now it could be the fourth time in 5 years as St. Joseph has a 3-0 lead. We go to the top of inning number nine as they look for some insurance. Scott Barron was at the plate when Josh Cassidy got trying to steal third base to close out the eighth inning. So he will lead off, and he swings and misses after a called strike, and now it's a 0-2 count to Barron, who is 0-for-3 in the game. Scott came in hitting .244 with two homers and 15 RBI. The new pitcher is Travis Booth for the Mudcats. He's the fourth pitcher in the game. Booth was an all-star this year as well. Pitches low, 1-2. Booth on the year is 1-1 with a 2.28 ERA, has two saves for the Mudcats. He's mainly been used out of the pen. So we're going to miss. He strikes out on four pitches. So Scott Barron 0-for-4 in the game. As Travis Booth plays his college baseball at California Baptist, a Division II school. He is from Chino Hills, California, went to Ontario Christian High School. 6'3", 200-pound, right-handed thrower, 1-1. Win-loss record. First pitch he throws to Max Ayoub is in there for strike number one. Max 0-for-1 in the game, 0-for-9 as a Mustang, but he's walked twice in this game. See if he can get off the schneid and get that first base hit in a Mustang uniform. He will get it. He lines one up the middle. He got jammed and fought it off. The second baseman, Gonzalez, lunged for it and couldn't quite get to it, and he is off the schneid. He's now 1-for-10 as a Mustang gets his first base hit of his St. Joseph career. A one-out base hit up the middle. It'll look like a hard hit line drive up the box, but it just snuck through as Gonzalez nearly got to that thing, but now it'll be up to 8-9 to continue and get a rally going here with one down and one on. 3-0 St. Joseph here in the top of the ninth inning. Jerry Houston will bat for St. Joseph, the second baseman for the Mustangs. Houston 0-for-2 in the game. He's been hit by a pitch. He flew out to deep center field back in the second, and he popped up on the infield, a shallow left field to the shortstop, Morales. He looks at ball one. He's ahead 1-1, no strikes. Travis Booth tries a fastball. It's right down the middle. That's Booth's best pitch, it looks like. Pretty good velocity from the youngster. Just wrapped up his freshman year at California Baptist. Made 13 relief appearances. Was 0-1 with a 5.54 ERA for Cal Baptist. There's an off-speed pitch. He tries to prove me wrong, and he throws it for a strike. 1-2, 1-out. Ayub, a one-out single. Jackson Schnurbusch waits on deck. Houston wiggles the bat. Fastball line deep to left field. Going back is Douglas. He's on the run. He will not get to it. It's going to one-hop the wall. Rounding third base is Max Ayub, and he will score standing up as Jerry Houston adds some insurance to this score with a one-out double off the wall in left, and Jerry Houston gets his second double and his 11th RBI as a Mustang as St. Joseph now has a 4-0 lead here in the ninth inning on back-to-back base hits. Where they've crushed some balls here in this eighth and ninth inning. Richardson, Cassidy, and Houston have just absolutely crushed some balls that have one-hopped or gone off the wall. But a stand-up double that drives an IU ball all the way from first base. So Travis Booth, their all-star closer, having some trouble after the strikeout of Barron. And now a foul off to the right side by Jackson Schnurbusch. Jackson got everything going in the eighth. He was hit by a pitch. It would have been ball four, so he was going to have a leadoff walk, but he got the leadoff hit by a pitch and came in a score on the triple on the next. He got sacrificed a second and the triple by Richardson. Jackson has a base hit in the game. He is 1-for-2. 1-for-2 with a single up the middle, ground out to short, and then that hit by a pitch and a run scored. Called strike, makes it no balls and two strikes as Orencio Fisher waits on deck. One out, runner at second base, 4-0 St. Joseph now here in the ninth. He swings, and a swinging bunt down the third base line. It'll be charged by Ethier, and he makes the throw, and Burns will keep his foot on the base as he had a lunge towards second base to try and grab it, and he did. It was very close. Matt Johnson was going to argue, but Johnny Coy says, his foot was on the base. Don't argue. It's not going to matter anyway, but he probably would have. Two outs now, runner at third base for Orencio Fisher. Let's see if Oak can get an RBI on his birthday. He's 0-for in the game, had that sacrifice bunt in the eighth inning. And now he takes a good swing at that one. And again, radio doesn't do the play justice that he made to close out the eighth inning. Matt Tritt and I were talking about this. He barehanded the ball in right. He didn't use the glove, hasn't played much outfield. He did for Western this past year and now for the Mustangs. But he barehands the ball in one motion, throws to second, one hop, and gets the runner. Ground ball toward third. Ethier charges, gets a nice high hop at his waist. He'll throw out O. But Orencio Fisher and the Mustangs lead as we go to the bottom of inning number 9. Jerry Houston drives in a run with a double with one out in the ninth inning, and they add some insurance. 4-0 St. Joseph as we go to the bottom of the ninth right here on ESPN 1550 and uclicktv.com.
Visit Horizon Equipment, your local John Deere dealer. They're just a few miles east of St. Joseph on 36 Highway, and they have a wide selection of John Deere riding mowers, zero-turn mowers, and garden tractors. Let their professionals help fit you to the right equipment for your job. They also have a top-notch John Deere parts and service department, and if you want it to run like a Deere, it has to be a Deere. Give them a call today and find out about discounts and financing options. You'll find a full line of John Deere at Horizon Equipment at Route C and 36 Highways, just east of St. Joseph.
takes hard work and dedication to have a winning team. The Mustangs showed us this last season. And here at the new Anderson Ford, we share the same commitment to our customers. Whether it's sales or service, the new Anderson Ford will serve your needs by always doing what is right. Stop by and check out the new Anderson Ford, 2207 Roosevelt Highway.
Anderson Ford, your regional Ford superstore. Online at AndersonAutoGroup.com.
It's one of the busiest times of the year to buy and sell real estate in Northwest Missouri. So Mustangs fans, step up to the plate and hit a home run when you choose Reese Nichols Eye Capital Realty to be part of your team. From new construction homes to townhomes, investment properties, commercial listings, and more, we've got all the bases covered. Why choose us for your real estate journey? Our agents, our expertise, our partners. Call Reese Nichols Eye Capital Realty today. We must be doing something right.
You're listening to St. Joseph Mustangs Baseball on ESPN 1550.
We go to the bottom of the ninth inning, and Steve D'Amico will come on to try and finish out the win tonight and finish out a Mink League North championship. If he can get the final three outs, this will be his first appearance since giving up the three runs against Joplin on Saturday. He's been outstanding throughout the entire year, and unfortunately that one will haunt him a little bit, I'm sure, because, again, he has had such a good year, but they have it happens every once in a while, and it did to Steve on Saturday, but he'll try and bounce back and have some wiggle room. He'll face off against John Remick. He fouls one off to start his at-bat. No balls and a strike. Steve D'Amico, the Mustang closer. It's a non-save situation right now as they lead by four, but Steve on the season is 1-1 with a 2.84 ERA. He does have four saves and five opportunities. There's a off-speed pitch in there for strike number two. No balls and two strikes to John Remick, who has a double, one of the three hits for the St. Joseph, or for the Chillicothe Mudcats this evening. D'Amico from the wine. Curveball is outside. One ball, two strikes to count. Steve gave up three runs in the game on Saturday. He had given up one earned run all season long. He's only allowed 9 hits in 12 and two-thirds innings. He's had 19 Ks and 5 walks in those 12 and two-thirds. So he's been an overpowering closer, very, very good. Just had the hiccup on Saturday in the dirt. Now a two-ball and two-strike count. A win tonight gives the Mustangs the Mink League North Division Championship. St. Joseph will try and do that for the fourth time in 5 seasons. They lead 4-0. They didn't score, neither team scored until the ninth. Foul off the end of the bat. Two balls, two strikes after that foul ball. D'Amico from the wine gets the sign from Max Ayub, who's behind the plate tonight for St. Joseph. Fastball called strike three inside corner. And they throw it around the horn, and now two outs away from a Mink League championship. We'll talk to Matt Johnson after the game, get his thoughts. Four nothing St. Joseph, 4 runs, 6 hits, 1 error for the Mustangs. And now a fly ball deep to right center field going over is Richardson, and he will chase it down as he sprints towards right center and makes the catch. Mustangs are one out away from a North championship. Richardson has played very well in center field, again filling in for Kyle Richards, who got picked up by the T-Bones. And now it'll be Tyler Burns to try and extend the season for Chillicothe. Here's D'Amico. And the pitch is a curveball that misses low and away for ball number one. Tyler Burns 0 for 3 so far in the game. Burns hitting 247, no homers, 7 RBI. Here's the 1-0 pitch, fastball outside and high. Mustangs scored 3 in the 8th to break open a scoreless game. Two of them came with 2 outs to really break it open, and then they got a 2 or 1 out double in the 9th inning from Jerry Houston. Richardson the big blow with the triple, check swing, pop up out of play after the right side, now 2-1. Again, the scoring started with a hit by a pitch, a sacrifice bunt, and a triple by Jacob Richardson. There's a wild pitch to score Richardson from third base with two down, and then a two-out double by Josh Cassidy. Two balls, one strike, two outs. Base is empty here in the ninth. Fastball low. D'Amico now with 20 strikeouts and five walks in 13 and one-third innings of relief this season. Hasn't thrown a ton, hasn't needed to. There haven't been a lot of close games. The Mustangs have only played 6 one-run games. Here's a walk. D'Amico will walk him with two outs now, and Aaron Cryer will come up now. He's one for two in the game, the right fielder for Chillicothe. The Mudcats only have three hits in the game. Two are doubles. Had a leadoff single in the eighth inning that was erased. Now they have four. They've got four hits. Now they've changed on the scoreboard. As I was talking about that. They had two in the eighth inning, but only had three batters up because Gonzalez with a leadoff single. Then a one pitch out, a line drive to second. They doubled him off at first base, and then Schwartz had a single, but he tried to extend that to a double and got thrown out by Arencio Fisher. Fastball for strike one from D'Amico. Dreyer one for two in the game. He doubled down the third baseline, stole a bag, and was stranded in the fifth inning. From the stretch for the first time is D'Amico. Checks first base. And an off-speed pitch in the dirt for ball number one. Walks are what hurt D'Amico in that loss on Saturday. He gave up a hit, but then walked two to load the bases and gave up the three runs. And again, as I mentioned, only now six walks all summer long, but three came in that inning. One night after Ramsey Scott's walk-off. Checks his swing there. It's in the dirt again. Two balls and a strike. Two down, runner at first base. Mustangs lead 4-0 here in the bottom of inning number nine. So Dave's only going to make up one of their makeup games tomorrow against Ozark, so a win here will give the Mustangs the Mink League North Division Championship. D'Amico's pitch, fastball blew it by him, swing and a miss, one strike away. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, runner at first base, a 4-0 St. Joseph lead. Zach Douglas is on deck, he hopes to get an at-bat. The pitch from D'Amico, fastball blew it by him, he struck him out, and the St. Joseph Mustangs have won the Mink League North Division Championship for the fourth time in five seasons, as St. Joseph is now 34-14 and 27-13 in the Mink League as they shut out the Chillicothe Mudcats this evening. The final score, 4-0 here in Chillicothe. The Mustangs are Mink League North champions here in 2015. We'll come back with our post games. This is Mustangs Baseball on ESPN 1550 and uclicktv.com.
Equipment in Savannah is your source for lawn and garden equipment. They've got the complete lineup of Woods mowers, Kubota utility mowers and tractors, Cub Cadet mowers, and Land Pride equipment attachments. Everything you need to keep your lawn and garden looking great all year long. Dürr Equipment is here to help, from commercial to residential. Dürr has the lawn care equipment you need. Stop by Dürr Equipment for your lawn and garden equipment on Highway 71 north of Savannah.
Have you been to the Ground Round lately? It's where there's always a fusion of flavor. You'll find just what you're looking for.
Your favorite half-price appetizers, Monday through Friday, outrageous nachos, chicken quesadilla, spinach artichoke dip, and much more.
The Ground Round has the best daily happy hour from 3 to 6 p.m. and 9 p.m. to close, offering 15 flavors of Long Island iced teas. Good friends, good times, great food. See what's new at the historic downtown Ground Round on the corner of 6th and Edmund. We've got what you like. Ground Round.
Today's Mustang game is brought to you in part by Duval Lawn Care Incorporated. Do you have unsightly weeds in your lawn? Do you want a greener, richer looking lawn? Then give Duval Lawn Care a call. Duval Lawn Care serves commercial and residential customers in St. Joseph, North Kansas City, and the surrounding area. For a personalized proposal and a great looking lawn, give the folks at Duval Lawn Care a call at 816-662-2222. That's 662-2222.
Dave Rigger back in Chillicothe as the St. Joseph Mustangs are in the Mink League Championship game here in 2015. Their fourth Mink League North title in the last five seasons as they defeat the Chillicothe Mudcats by a final score of 4-0 as St. Joseph now 34-14 this season and they improved their Mink League record to 27-13 on the year. And we are joined here on postgame by the manager of the St. Joseph Mustangs. Matt Johnson joins me now as you are Mink League North Division champions with this win tonight. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you. I had no idea. Really?
Yep.
Wow.
Today is only going to make up one more game with Ozark tomorrow, and then they have the game with you. So you're 2.5 up. They could make up one game tomorrow if you would lose, and they would win, make it 1.5. They can't get you now. You're up 2.5. It's
well,
done.
I'll be darned.
You are the Mink League North Division champions. What's it mean?
That's awesome. I mean, it's really surprising. I mean, so I really don't have the words for it, but I mean, just for these guys to do what they've done all year. I mean, we started off really hot. We persevered throughout the whole season. And at this point, we've been, just kind of playing good, playing well. I mean, we've won 8 of our last 10, I think is what it is now. And we've come up with a lot of big hits. But, I mean, it means a lot. These guys have really earned it.
And the North now, it's stacked. With Sedalia moving from the South to the North, all four North teams have a lot of tradition. Your guys has a long history, but it's great history in the 7 years you've been here. Clarinda does, Chillicothe does, Sedalia does. I mean, the best teams, Nevada, you can mix them in there too, but the best teams are in the North. And it was a battle, but it says a lot about your guys to battle through everything, have ups and downs, and win this North title.
It does. I mean, considering, we're 1-4 against Sedalia. I think we ended up 5-1 against Clarinda, 3-3 against Chillicothe. It just goes to show, like you said, exactly what the North is like. I mean, when I was told this is what was going to happen in the North, and I said, well, this is going to be one heck of a summer with a lot of competitive baseball, and it lived up to everything that we thought it would be.
Let's talk about this game a little bit. You get 3 in the 8th, and again, it wasn't fun really until the 8th inning, but Jackson had a great at-bat. It was going to be a walk anyway, but then he got the hit by a pitch. He sacrificed playing some small ball, but then all of a sudden your guys kind of came alive when that happened. He got on base. That was only the second runner you had on base in the first inning. It ended up being through 9 innings, but through 8 innings at the time. And for him to get on base, lead off, hit by a pitch, energize your guys. Then Richardson hammers one, Cassidy hammers one, Jerry hammers one of the 9th inning, so your guys kind of got going there.
Yeah, I think after last night's emotional win, I mean, people don't realize how much it really sucks out of you when you put it in there. I kind of had to, even myself, I had to get myself motivated to be here. And you just tell some of the guys, it's just, all right, here we go. It was there. It just wasn't in the same intensity as it was last night. So, we came up big when we had to. It's been kind of that way all year. We've come up with big innings when we've had to, whether it's been early in the ball game or in late. And we finally found our swings late.
Nice to see guys like Cassidy and Jerry and those guys again. They've had ups and downs throughout the year, but boy, they crushed some balls, and those are big to what you had. Again, you could only came up with one run in that thing, and it's a whole three.
It's a little tighter. Guys are playing a little bit tighter. Now we score 3. Now they can play a little bit looser. They can have a little bit more fun with it. And they're able to make a couple mistakes if we happen to. But, I mean, we defensively were really sound. Jerry had a great game.
4 double plays.
It was phenomenal. He did a nice job turning double plays. The range of Richardson out in outfield. Is this now another guy that we can play in center with Jordan Powell now that Kyle Richards is gone. So I really like where our heads are at this point.
We talked kind of in-game about Blake Collins. He got in a little trouble but worked out of it through 6 innings. But Logan Jacek, bouncing back, his last 2 outings haven't been great. They've been against Sedalia. He had a loss, and then he came back last night, gave up a couple of runs, was a little bit wild. But I'll tell you what, he threw really good tonight. And in that 8th inning, they had 2 base hits, but then your defense bails you out. And Radio does not do Arencio's play justice in left field. A bare hand on the money with one hop to get those outs. But Logan Jacek, a great job.
He did, and I like seeing that from what he did the night before. It showed a little sense of maturity that he's starting to figure out. He was a guy that was just throwing at the beginning of the year. Now he's a guy that's pitching, and once we get to the point where we can spot whatever pitch we want to throw, the velocity will come, the confidence will come.
Yeah, he looked confident tonight.
He did, and that's what we need out of him. And for him to be kind of that bridge guy, he gives us another guy in the bullpen. Because postseason, we're not going to have 7 starters. It's just not the way it's going to work. I mean, we're going to have guys in the pen, and we're going to shorten up ball games. And for him to come out like that, that gives us and him and Ross, early on in the ball game. Now our back end is, D'Amico, Hill, Aspergren, Medina. We don't have to go, 5-6 innings with our starters. We can go 4, and we can turn it over to the bullpen late.
Is that kind of why you hung with Blake and then put Logan out there again for a second consecutive night for a couple of innings to save the bullpen a little bit here as you near the postseason?
It was kind of a mix of that. We wanted to save it, see where we're at, because if we didn't have to use Umberto tonight, we needed to get DeMeco back on the mound after what happened at home.
Right.
We could have scored 10 runs. He was still going to come out and throw. But it was kind of another way of getting Logan back out there, because we have confidence in him. And if we kind of sit him and don't throw him in those situations, that confidence, maybe he built some that day, now it's gone. And I want him to know that we're confident in bringing him in tight ball games to get the job done.
I know the North Division title's great, but it's not what you play for.
No.
You want to get to that Mink League Championship game, and it's a game this year, and now you're there. So there's a lot left to play for, isn't there?
There is, and this is the first step. We talk about it every single year. We win the North to give us an opportunity to win a championship, and then when we win that championship, then we go on to the NBC and kind of finish it out from there. So we got a lot of work still to do to accomplish our goals, but the first step is done. Now we need to move on to step two.
And again, right now, you guys have decided as an organization, if you don't win the Mink League, you're not going to the NBC. So that makes it that much more important, too, to win that one game.
It does. And I don't know if you really want to advance on if you don't win it.
I agree with you.
I mean, every round that you see in every other sport, you know, in college baseball, if you don't win the Super Regional, the at-large bid doesn't get into the College World Series.
Right.
So it's just one of those things that, you know, we, like I said, that's kind of our core values in St. Joe's, that we need to win something to move on.
Now, with wrapping this up, these next two games, do you position your lineup and your pitching staff to how you want it in that championship game?
I think we do, and we're going to have some conversations on the bus tonight of how we're going to map this out, because Dixon's scheduled to throw tomorrow. We had Preston scheduled to throw on Thursday, so now I got a really big coin flip to do here with those two guys.
Who are you going
to
pitch in that?
Now we just got to decide, okay, who's the better starter guy? Who's the guy that we can bring out of the pen in those situations? And just there's a lot of communication, a lot of thought that we're going to have to take into who's going to start on.
And we know it's against Nevada, and again, you play them tomorrow. So.
Yep.
Yep. Don't tip your hat too much. Although, again, you know each other anyway. It's not like you're going to tip your hat and then, okay, now I know what they're going to do.
Yeah. Yeah, there's really no secrets anymore.
Right.
Everybody knows how to pitch everybody. They've picked up a couple guys, and, you know, just like we've picked up guys. And mm-hmm. It's going to be an interesting way to finish things out.
It will, but it will be for a champion. Is it on Friday for sure? Do we know that?
As far as I know, unless they change things. But as far as I know, it's going to be Friday.
As of right now.
And then I don't know if it's, I guess, are we still playing for home field? I don't know. I haven't really looked at the standings. So that's something also that was got to be out there.
Okay, yeah, I'm pretty sure you've got home field. Again, you're 5-0 against them. You have a better record. So I would think that you have home field wrapped up too.
Yeah.
So. Stranger things have happened.
Let's have to see how it plays out.
Hell, you didn't even know you won the Mink League North.
I had no idea.
Where's the champagne?
I know. To be absolutely honest, it was totally clueless tonight.
Congratulations.
Thanks, Dave.
Matt Johnson, manager of your St. Joseph Mustangs. They're victorious tonight 4-0 over Chillicothe and are the Mink League North Division champions here in 2015. They go for the Mink League title again. As of right now, we know it will be on Friday night against the Innovative Griffins at home at Phil Welch Stadium. That will wrap things up. The Mustangs are now 34-14, 27-13 in the Mink League, and they are the North Division champions as they beat Chillicothe again 4-0, our final score. Thanks to Jim Bly for helping out, as always, on uClickTV.com. Thank you for listening. I am Dave Riggert. So long, everybody, from Chillicothe, Missouri.